cheering from
board. Collect the newest 2023 AFL footy cards, available at Sports Card World, Regent Arcade.
Plenty of AFL retirement announcements today. North Melbourne's Ben Cunnington will play his final game this weekend. Essendon ruckman Andrew Phillips will call time on his footy career at the end of the season. West Coast's Luke Shuey will also retire at the end of the season. The Matildas will be watching closely tonight when France take on World Cup newcomer Morocco. The winner will play Australia in Brisbane on Saturday for a place in the semi-finals. And Athletics Australia has announced its 67-athlete squad for the World Championships in Budapest this month. Now checking 5AA traffic.
At Blair Road close, 0-5 James Road at Old Blair Road. Elizabeth got a crash, Main North Road near Yorktown Road, and Hindmarsh Road closes due to the soccer, Manton Street from around 5:30 this afternoon. Busy Alex Road at South Road with the camera today, Langman Grove at Felixstowe. It's the 40 Winks Sleep event of the year. Get up to 50% off mattresses and up to 30% off furniture, plus free local delivery. Hurry, limited time only, 40 Winks, serious about sleep. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Now the 5AA weather.
Get the Toyota forklift advantage. Visit toyotamaterialhandling.com.au.
Sunny this afternoon, showers developing tomorrow 20, Thursday a morning shower or 2 15, 15 again on Friday with a possible shower. Right now it's 18 degrees. Now let's hear what's happening on Nine News tonight.
I'm Kate Collins. Tonight, police rescue two South Australian children after a global sting that left FBI agents dead. The parents of a young hit-run victim give harrowing evidence as their son's accused killer stands trial. A joyride ends in drama for a carjacker on the run, and a suspected Russian spy arrested over a plot to kill Ukraine's president. See the full story live on Nine News at 6 p.m. and on Nine Now.
The 5AA Sports Show. Rowie and Timmy G.
Now looking to release Kate McFord, and she's onside. Kate McFord, big chance, Australia on the angle. Four visits. What a goal, Kate McFord. And Stadium Australia erupts on the angle. Van Egmond. Hayley Russo plays a third goal of this Women's World Cup. And it may be a goal that carries Australia all the way.
It's 6 minutes after four, and it was a historic night last night in Sydney. We'll reflect on it all and more as I welcome Tim Ginever and Stephen Rowe.
Thank you, Sammy. Yeah, waking up to this glorious Adelaide day, having watched the Matildas win 2-0 over Denmark last night. They advanced the quarterfinals. Timmy G, they were superb. 6.54 million people watched on Seven. Last year's grand final, 5.76. We, my friend, are in Tilly fever.
Absolutely.
We've caught it.
The thing about it is the world game. And that's what I think it's always going to have over Australian rules for starters. But every what would you say, state, every city, every country plays this game. And that's why it's so popular. And they're causing momentum. They're the ones lifting it up and making us go with them.
They're catching our hearts. I was saying to you in the sport room before we walked in, I can't remember the last sporting event where my daughter Tori, who's not really into sport, but will sit there with us if it's any good, James, Jody and I, because Gemma's married with a little one, sat and watched the entire game of any sporting event. And we did, and we were captivated. Here's the moment Sam Kerr ran onto the park for her first run for the Matildas in the World Cup. It was about the 80th minute.
But this, as we hear the roar of the stadium on their feet for their hero Sam Kerr, a double sub with her and Courtney Vine. And what a moment this is for Sam Kerr. The little smile that Sam Kerr gave as she jogged onto the field, a really quite emotional moment for her to make her first minutes at this home World Cup.
Now, we know she's had a calf. She's a Chelsea star. She's our star. 122 caps. She's had 63 goals. Probably the best striker slash forward in the world right now. What a weapon to unleash for the next however long we go.
I don't know about you, but my heart was in my mouth for the whole 15 minutes. I didn't know whether it was a good thing or a bad thing. I'm thinking is the game's in the bag. I'm resting her. I'm making sure that calf's 100%. So absolutely on the edge of my seat for that 15 minutes.
She looked all right.
The game, as far as I was concerned, was over.
Okay.
What I was worried about is that calf going to hold up.
Okay.
Because she does it then, she's out. That is it. Tournament, bye. Mm. Goodbye. So I had my heart in my mouth. Whether it was the right move, we got Craig Foster on after 4:30. I'm going to ask him whether it was the right move or not. In the end, it paid off. She got through.
Got her nerves out the way.
Got the nerves out the way. She got a couple of ugly passes out the way. Then she showed her class, and she's going to make a big difference. Oh. And I think the whole thing about it is we've built the whole World Cup in Australia around her. She has been the poster girl, but she hasn't been there.
Nah.
So that's why it was such an important moment. And she got through it, and I'm so pleased that she did because I was feeling ill.
Yeah. Here's Sam post-match.
Yeah, I feel good. I mean, I think I was a little bit rusty, but I felt great. So, like I said, such relief. I'll sleep better tonight than I have the last 3 weeks, so it'll be a good sleep for me.
She's the talk of Australia, probably the world. So when we got her on, buddy?
Yeah, yep.
No, don't give me that.
What? What are you
when
talking about?
Have we got which Sam Kerr on? Your family friend.
I spoke to Dad last Wednesday. You heard him. As soon as she's got that cup in her hand, she's straight in there.
Are the Matildas right now, our favourite national sporting team ever? Have you say 8223 00 00. I love the Wallabies when Johnny Eels was the captain.
Yeah, he was awesome.
I did enjoy that. Ricky Ponting, how he led the team with all those wins in the test matches, and Warney was out in front, and McGrath was doing the all-wars. That was a pretty good moment. But, God, before the World Cup was on, and I actually tested myself at the sporting desk today, I said, well, I wonder how many Matildas I knew 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago.
Yep.
And I got to about five. Hmm. I can name the starting 11.
Yeah.
I even know the coach's name. Can't pronounce it, but I know it.
See, what it's done is it's absolutely unified
the
country together, but it's also unified the family lounge room together. Exactly what you said is where male, female.
It's the world game.
My dog was sitting up there watching. Everybody's on the couch engrossed in it because we are invested. Mm. So that's the beauty of it. It's so broad that it's carrying the momentum with all of us and every member of the family.
What's yours? Give us a favourite national sporting team.
I cannot and I will not ever go past the 1983 America's Cup. Because that carried a nation everybody in it was interested. It was incredible. And we did something that nobody else had done for 135 years or whatever and took it out of America. And it still sits with me as the greatest team effort.
Australia's so if the girls did this is going to be up there, isn't it?
Absolutely.
Because this is the holy grail.
Yeah, incredible.
The men will never get there.
The doors are opening.
Yeah.
The doors are opening. Okay. You know, we spoke to Bianca Chatfield, and she said she was going to pick. I think she was going to pick. No, who was it? It was going to pick USA.
Yeah.
Oh, it was Grace Gill last night. She was going to pick USA. Then I said, "Well, they're gone." She said, "Germany."
Germany.
They're gone. So now it's opened right up. She said, "Well, there's no clear favourite. Maybe Australia.
Australia and England might end up that way." Okay, so are the Matildas your favourite national sporting team ever? Have you say 8223 00 00. Matildas coach is Tony Gustafsson, who I named Goofy round one.
You did.
Did I? Did I not?
Yes, you did.
If they win, they'll knighthood him.
Well,
and I'll still call him Goofy.
I don't think we can do that.
I'm still not quite on board. Well, I know we can't, but someone
figuratively.
Would. Yeah. There you go. Our Prime Minister, Anthony Albanese, reckons if the Matildas win the World Cup, we'll have a public holiday. Now, I think he said it a bit tongue-in-cheek.
Did he?
He said it'll go to the Senate.
Did he?
Well, he did.
I think he was thinking seriously about it. I think he's feeling the room on that one.
But Albo, our Diamonds just won their 12th World Cup in England in netball. How do you reckon they'd feel?
Yeah.
Do we get a holiday for that?
No, just
and haven't we got a one-day cricket one coming up?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, just cut it out.
And our national women's team just have won the last nine. we're never going to be able to work.
You can't do that. Exactly.
Hey, 8223 00 00, your favourite national team. Timmy.
Yes.
Port Adelaide.
Yes.
They're dropping like flies.
Oh, why? Who else?
Scotty Lysett. Knee.
Yes.
McKenzie, PCL. Knee.
Be back.
Now we're hearing Charlie Dixon may have a bung foot, a busted foot. Have a listen to Chad.
He was in my neighbourhood up in the hills yesterday. He popped in and he still wasn't walking too well on that foot. So he'll have some follow-up scans again, a different scan than he had late last week. But he'd have to be in some doubt this week.
Is that good news?
That says he is out. That says he is out.
He's out.
If Chad said that, then So it just says to me how serious that foot is. I mean, we asked Chris Davies on Friday. I just said, is that going to need post-season surgery? And he walked around it, but I'm pretty sure that it's a yes.
I'm going to ask you again. That could be a blessing in disguise.
Well, we did say about the way they go into 50, they always lower the eyes when he's not there. But you, I think you still need that. You need a firing Finlayson if you've not got
there
a Dixon.
You go. He's in my team. Is he in your team?
You know
Charlie's in my team.
But you know where I want to play him.
Where?
In ruck.
Yeah. What was that thing you did?
Chuck in ruck.
Great news for Port. Alia back. My boy Jones back. Bergman back. Farrell back. Finlayson back. Five reasonable ins.
Yeah, well, that would probably be the difference between you winning in Geelong and not.
Yeah,
those names.
And this time of year, AFL retirements, as we go into the break and take your calls, they're coming thick and fast. There's only three games left. Headlined by Buddy Franklin, we know that. Eagle star and captain Luke Shuey just pulled the pin. He joined Shannon Hearn. Crows' last game of the year, Saturday night there, round 24. Win could mean the difference about a top eight or not. They're going to be fired up with those stars out, just saying. Jack Zeeble's done on 277 games. There's Phillips, there's Hall, Tarrant, Castagna. Pick six, Fisher McAsee, after 10 games and three seasons. Will he get in the motorcade? Grand final motorcade?
I don't think so.
Wouldn't have thought so. But the big one's North's Ben Cunnington. He just couldn't get going after his cancer battle. He retired today, almost a year after recovering from testicular cancer. It was an emotional farewell. Have a listen.
Today, I'm calling time on my AFL career. This will be my last week. I started as a shy young country kid. Moving away from home wasn't easy for me, but I can't believe I've lasted this long. I couldn't be more prouder of what I've achieved on and off the field in the 14 years at this level. I've got to thank and acknowledge all the players, coaches and staff that have come and gone in my time. You guys have helped shape the player I was and the person I am today. And I feel I'm leaving in such a great position and ready to take my next chapter of life.
Oh, I just wish him health and happiness. Got a lovely family. Goldstein to Cunnington is how it used to be.
Yeah.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, he was an unbelievable clearance king.
I think Jack Zeeble was around there too.
He was. 237 games. He holds the AFL record for contested possessions in a game. Have a guess.
Wow.
How many? Just a stab.
Oh, 20.
32.
Oh, wow.
32 contested possessions in a game.
Yeah.
He was an absolute ripper, and at his best, he was almost hard to beat. Favourite national team?
Absolutely.
I'm saying the Tillies. What's yours?
Fair enough, too. Give us a call, 8223-0000. Hey, Roe, we just got a unique homestyle foods text, and it said, Timmy, I read this morning in the death notices, Ron Elloway had passed away. Port Adelaide fullback during the 60s and 70s, played with many greats, including Ebert, Cale, Woit, Clayton, and Cornsey would have played against him. He did. And I knew Ron pretty well. We used to catch up quite a bit at the past player stuff. It was his funeral today, so my condolences to the family and to Barbie's lovely wife, who just is an absolute ripping lady. So, and it's one of those moments, Rowie, where we always have a catch-up on Boxing Day, and I, for some reason, caught Ron, and me and him sat for 2 hours talking. And I think to myself now, wasn't that good? Wasn't that great that I had that 2 hours with him?
Oh, beautiful.
And just learnt all about his life and had a terrific chat. So, to Barb and everybody, our condolences.
God
Excellent
bless.
Work. Well said. It's 17 after 4. Campo's joining us on the show in Coach's Corner after 5 o'clock. Craig Foster to enjoy and celebrate the Matildas' win last night in the quarterfinals. They are through to George Bailey, the chair selector of the Australian cricket team, to join us. We've got more Port Locker Room tickets to give away to this Sunday's game against the Giants, plus another double pass to the 777 suite at the OTR Super Sprint next weekend. We will take your call shortly. Who is your favourite national sports team? 8223-0000.
Rowie and Timmy G on the 5AA Sports Show. 5AA, Adelaide's number one station for sports. Thanks to Rossdale Homes, home of the absolute fixed price contract. No builder's variations, no nasty surprises.
Way, way back in 1974, Gliderol Garage Doors began manufacturing and installing garage doors in South Australia. A lot has changed since then, but our commitment to quality remains as strong as ever. We have garage door solutions of all kinds. Not only do we have traditional doors, our timber look or custom designer doors ensure your house will make a style statement. For a free measure and quote and helpful advice, give Gliderol a call, 1300 799 177, or go to gliderol.com.au.
Did you know that Frank Sinatra's My Way was voted the number one choice of funeral songs? With Time to Say Goodbye not far behind. And the number one choice for a simple, affordable service? SimplicityFunerals.com.au.
Now, when you build with Lamar Holmes, you better start planning your housewarming because it'll be here before you know it. How good's that? Lamar Holmes have the advantage of moving a lot faster because they never take on too much, which means they can manage their trades, their delivery dates much better. It's all in order. So keep, you know, in a couple of months, you could actually move in. Not years, you could be right in there, rare on the go.
Blooming hell. Plus, right now, if you build with Lamar Homes, they'll throw in a whopping $35,000 to spend on your concreting, landscaping, fencing. The costs can really mount up. And when you get to the end of your house, you've got the frame, you've got everything. You walk in and you go, wow, this is great. And you go outside and go, God, we've still got all this to do.
Looks unmade. That. Looks like an unmade bed.
That's exactly right. $35,000 to spend on concreting, landscaping and fencing. It goes a long way. That is sensational. Some T's and C's apply. Visit lamarhomes.com.au. Lamar Homes, here today, home tomorrow, sooner.
How easily could you save hundreds off your energy bills? That easy. Switch out your gas or electric hot water system for an energy-efficient heat pump with EcoVantage. Then sit back and save up to 70% on your water heating costs. And get it supplied and installed for as little as $0, thanks to government-facilitated subsidies. Yep, new hot water system from $0 that saves you hundreds. Pump your energy bills down with ecovantage.com.au.
Go Vita, your local health food shops. Over 30 years health and wellness experience and over 300 natural health practitioners specialising in you.
Hi, I'm Sue from Go Vita Semaphore. Fusion Mood Support supports health, mood, balance with added zinc and vitamin B6. Get 60 veggie caps now for $33.75. Save 35%. Always read the label and follow directions for use.
Go Vita, Colonnades, Fairview Green, Marion, Mount Barker, Manopara, Semaphore and Tanunda.
Let New Zealand take your breath away on an exclusive 17-day getaway with Holiday Wonders Mitcham. Fly direct from Adelaide with Air New Zealand and experience the best of what the North and South Islands have to offer, with meals, accommodation and so much more included, and more highlights than any comparable New Zealand trips. Right now, it's our best value ever. Save up to $980 per couple. Call now or visit holidaywonders.com.au. Holiday Wonders, Blair Road, Mitcham.
With more stores close to home and everyday low prices, great food lives at Foodland, the mighty South Aussies.
Roey and Timmy G on the 5AA Sports Show.
21 minutes after four on your Tuesday afternoon, Craig Foster to join us very shortly on the back of our Matildas 2-0 win last night. They are into the quarterfinals. We'll take your calls. Are the Matildas your favourite ever national sporting team? $50 Powers voucher up for grabs. First, let's check your traffic.
At Belanga Road, closed 5, it's James Road. It's closed between Old Blair Road and Sheoak Road. Elizabeth, crash Main North Road, New Yorktown Road, and Hindmarsh got road closures there due to the soccer. That's between Manton Street and surrounding areas. Busy Aliffs Road at South Road with cameras, Bray Road, Felixstowe, and Commercial Road at Seaford. There are more than five near misses every week on Adelaide's Metropolitan Rail Network. Are you an accident waiting to happen? Your life isn't a risk worth taking. Watch out for trains. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Yeah, we're trying to find out whether the Matildas are your favourite national team ever. Mm. Let's go to the phones. We've got Steve on the line. Hello, Steve.
Boys. Hey, boys. It's first time caller, so go easy on me, boys.
Well, hey. Hey, hang on.
Is this Steve? This is Mr. Walco.
It is.
Yes. Well, look, I can't be too long. I'm on the way to a very important meeting with the CEO down the port. I think he's probably buying the first round now. Beautiful pilot off.
Mate, your segment's tomorrow night, mate.
Walco Guardian.
What are you bringing tonight for?
I just thought I'd ring you. It's great hearing two blokes try and sound as if they're experts on a sport they got no idea about.
Yeah, that's true. You got us.
Oh, yeah, that's the show.
But look, national sporting team, favourite one, another round ball game. And look, Timmy was actually earmarked for this sport when he was six. It's basketball, but unfortunately didn't grow after 6 years of age. So he had to play footy. But it's the mighty West Adelaide, or they national? Yeah, West Adelaide Bearcats in the grand final this Saturday night at the Powerhouse.
Oh, so, wow. Gee whiz.
Oh, yeah, right. The men's team. So I don't know if footy's on. Yeah, but that's the real game right there. Basketball, lad.
I think it actually clashes with the Matildas game by the sounds of that.
Oh, jeez. more. It was funny. You were saying about the Diamonds World Cup winners, but it's really more Commonwealth.
Yes.
That's right.
Cup call. Winners. Good more call. Than world, I'd say.
Yeah, this
anyway,
is the
boys, I'll let you go. I hear someone calling me. Yeah. I'll best go.
Good luck with that meeting.
Go
good
and
luck.
Put a Wilco blanky on your blanky. Hello, Britain.
And my favourite sporting team of the Diamonds.
Yes.
They've already done it.
They keep doing it, don't they, Brenton? That's the thing about them. They keep backing it up.
That's right.
Yeah, it's spot on, mate. Good call, buddy.
Should we have a public holiday, Brenton?
Oh,
that's a bit ridiculous.
Yeah, I'm with you.
Oh, good man.
Good on you, Brenton.
We've got Johnny from Ingle Farve. Go, John.
G'day, gents. Rowley, firstly, mate, calm down with the men's national soccer team. Of course they're not going to win if you don't have a positive attitude about them and say positive affirmations.
Thank you,
Johnny.
John.
Johnny, that's Timmy's thoughts too. We'll never host a men's FIFA, number one. And number two, we'll never win it.
That's only because
of course
the team,
we won't with that attitude. Hey, listen, gents, I really like the Boomers. I don't know if you remember that team. It's not about winning. It's about flying the flag. Shane Hill had to run around the shower to get wet, taking it up to Charles Barkley and co. They did pretty good. I also like Paddy Mills and the effort they put in last Olympics. So thanks, Jez. Hey, keep up the good work.
Great call. Good on you, Johnny. I agree with that. Paddy Mills united us.
Well, in the last one, excellent.
Oh,
excellent.
God,
and led us to our first medal ever.
There's the documentary coming up very soon called Rose Gold on the FIBA World Cup's coming up in a couple of weeks' time.
Right.
And it's all about the Australian team in the last World Cup making the bronze medal, which was an awesome story.
You know what would wreck the Boomers if we put that peanut in? Who's the one that we don't like?
Ben Simmons.
If he was in there, they'd go, bop-bop. Johnny, great call. I'll give you a $50 pounds voucher, mate.
Congratulations, John.
We're after your favourite national team on the back of the Tillies. Dion.
How you going, boys?
What's yours?
They only play one game in heaven, so my team is the Wallabies.
Wallabies, yeah. Now, look.
I nominated that, Dion.
We did make a reasonable comeback in that second game of the Bledisloe Cup. The first one was a bit of a stinker, but yeah. Gee,
a bit of useless soccer information for you.
Yeah.
When Sweden played Denmark in a soccer game as a home team, the names are SWE and then DEN. The leftover letters are DENMARK.
Oh, that's interesting.
Right, there you go. Well played.
That's the most random trivia you're going to get today. Thanks to Dion.
Alphabet.
If you were quick enough to work that out, you got to write that down, perhaps.
Letterology.
Got a unique home style food text here because it's Campo Day after 5.
It is.
Coach's Corner. We've got our pastries ready to rock and roll at 5.
Yummy.
Here's a text. My favourite team ever. Treaders, Timmy and Tugwell. What?
Yeah, I know. Something.
When are you a three-a team?
No, I think...
Port Adelaide games.
Oh, you call Port games.
Every now and then.
He went on to say three blokes who arrive at the ground in a UFO. What would that mean?
They are a bit different.
Yeah, all right.
That is really the odd couple, isn't it?
Yeah.
The odd couple.
Juniper with a big chin, Tugwell with a big nose, and Treaders with a big head.
Well, there you go. Here's one from Jack.
What is that harsh?
This is a question I do want to ask Campo after 5. We've heard about Port Adelaide. They're going to just ask the AFL for some clarity on the free kick.
And so they should.
One umpire.
One rooster.
Gave 15 free kicks to Geelong. So Jack says, look, here we go again. When things start going pear-shaped and, you know, pear and inverted commas.
Oh, it's in pear.
Yeah, you got it. In the season, we trot out the umpires being a problem with not enough free kicks. They're ensuring that this week's home game, they get a good run from the men in white. Well, I can't remember I'm wearing white anymore, and gain a much-needed win. Yeah, Jack, that'll be an interesting one to see what does happen. I don't know that's ever worked for teams that complain.
I don't think it hurts.
Sometimes it works against,
but, Jack, I'll ask you this. Do you think that is a bit unusual?
It's incredibly
unusual. Do you think that's
unusual.
A little bit of a...
Anomaly.
Anomaly. Mm. There's a magic word. Do you think that that's a bit... Well, I reckon there's something in that.
15 from one
umpire. One dude.
Including the Connor Rosie one. Yeah. Interesting.
I'd ask the question.
Yeah. I reckon what happens
And, Jack,
sometimes...
we're playing for keeps now. I mean, your 4 points, you got to your 4 points. There's three games left. Mm. And it's the difference between finishing with a home final or in the bottom of the top four or out of the top four or out of the top eight. The stakes are high, Jack.
Mm. We'll take that up with Campo, I reckon, after 5 o'clock in Coach's
Corner. Yeah, because I think Nathan Buckley said he never did it as a coach. I tried it once as a coach, and I think it ends up being a waste of time.
Can't change the situation.
That's exactly what they give you.
Before we go to the break, and we were after your favourite national sporting team, should we mention Liz Cambridge? No.
Miss Cambage. She's been in the news today.
Yeah, she has.
She's playing for Nigeria. That's the funniest thing I've heard today. No, we're not going to mention that. Do not mention it.
Incredible, isn't
that's
it?
That's in the bin.
28 minutes after four, we'll get to the headlines. And Craig Foster to join us next.
The 5AA Sports Show with Rowie and Timmy G. 5AA Breakfast.
The Prime Minister's committed to consider having a public holiday should the Matildas make the final.
So what, we all get to goof off and not go to work for a day? I think that's a stupid idea.
Informing Adelaide.
See, I reckon politicians should just shut their silly mouths when it comes to sport. The long and ignoble history, I mean, Paul Keating once said that Blocker Roach kicked a lot of tries when he played for Balmain. Most politicians are nerds and they've got no understanding of sport.
6 a.m. weekdays on 5AA.
He's got his hoodie up and his head down, scrolling through his feed while strolling across the road. He's testing his luck and his new headphones. Then suddenly, he's testing your brakes too. Stop and take time to ensure your car stops in time and the brakes are all you hit. Let Automasters test your brakes before someone else does. Call 1300 Automasters.
To celebrate 70 years in solar, Solar Heart is giving you the chance to win a Tesla Model 3 electric vehicle worth up to $70,000. Simply buy a Solar Heart solar power system, Solar Heart water heater, heat pump or home battery and enter for your chance to win. Get smart. Get Solar Heart. Terms and conditions apply. Visit solarheart.com.au for details. Open to AU residents 18 plus. Ends 30th of September 2023. SA permit T23/871.
This is Adelaide's 5AA.
Good afternoon. Mel Usher with the latest news headlines. Households are continuing to slow their spending as the rising cost of living bites into family budgets. The woman accused of murdering her parents with her own insulin, Raylene Polymiadis, has been granted home detention bail. Sinead O'Connor will be laid to rest tonight our time in the town she called home for many years in Islands County Wicklow. And in sport, the Women's World Cup comes to Hindmarsh again tonight when France play Morocco. Now checking 5AA traffic.
At Blair, we've got a road closed due to a fire. That's James Road between Old Blair Road and Sheerk Road. Elizabeth crashed there, Main North Road near Yorktown Road. And if you're around Hindmarsh, expect a few delays and road closures from 5:30. That's due to the soccer. It's around Manton Streets. Busy, Main North Road at Fairfield Road. With cameras today, Commercial Road, Seaford and Dalkeith Road at Seaford Rise. A massive $2.3 billion could be yours with the USA Mega Lotto. Hurry, draw closes at 9:30 a.m. tomorrow. Grab your tickets now at Lottery Office. office.com.au. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
The 5AA forecast clear tonight down to 8, showers developing tomorrow and 20. Right now it's 17 degrees. We'll have more news at 5 and as it happens on 5AA.
No, it's a pleasure. So look around at your leisure.
Malcolm Blight here. The team at Knowles Island Star Caravans design and build caravans from decades of experience. They know because they go caravanning. And 75% of their customers are repeat or referred customers. As I've been saying for years, you'll love the way they do business. Knowles Island Star Caravans.
Knowles Caravans, Knowles Caravans, Knowles Caravans, Knowles Caravans.
We're with Toop and Toop's Bronte Emanuel. Given current market conditions, what's the best method for selling property in Adelaide? Is it auction?
There are a number of options out there when it comes to method of sale. But having said that, we've achieved some outstanding results under auction conditions recently, especially with the very low stock levels in Adelaide.
Now, a little birdie tells me you and a couple of other Toop team members have won some auctioneering competitions recently.
Winning trophies isn't a priority for us, but it is satisfying to know we have such a powerful team of auctioneers at Toop and Toop.
Does it really matter, though?
A good auctioneer is a highly skilled negotiator who can read body language, knows how to maximise bidding and ultimately gets the deal done. A good auctioneer can be the difference between a mediocre result and an amazing one.
To find out more about Toop and Toop auction success, go to toop.com.au.
Her mum's on the phone. while she's on her skates.
Careful, honey. Don't get too close to the road.
Wait, stop!
Let Automasters test your brakes before someone else does. Call 1300 Automasters.
With more stores close to home and everyday low prices, great food lives at Foodland, the mighty South Aussies.
Roey and Timmy G on the 5AA Sports Show.
27 minutes to 5 on this Tuesday afternoon. Very soon, Scotty Camporeale in Coach's Corner with us, all thanks to Unique Homestyle Foods. We've also got the Australian Chair of Selectors in our cricket space, George Bailey, to join us. They've got the squads out for the World Cup and the tours of South Africa and India. Lots coming up for our cricketers. Plus, stay tuned for our cue to call if you want to get to the OTR Super Sprint next weekend. Once you hear us rev the engines, you can call in and take part in our quiz to get along to that massive event at the Bend.
Absolutely. Well, yeah, thanks, mate. That's good of you. Hey, I got a Unique Homestyle Food text here, and I don't mind this one. I'll ask your opinion on it, Stephen. G'day, love the show. I nominate Toby Green for All-Australian captain. What a year he's had, and what a player he is. Captain of the side, plays hard. It's a hard position. He plays small forward, rarely gets beaten, drags the side along with him and makes something happen. And then when the whips are cracking, really deserves it in my eyes. He said, considering Hawkins was gifted one last year, nothing against Hawkins, but great players. Your thoughts, please. Troy.
That is a great text.
It is. I'm with him on Toby.
Oh, God. I think he's third or fourth as a small, medium-sized forward who mainly plays midfield or does midfield minutes and goes forward. If there was one player I could grab from another club, it'd be him.
I know.
He is a genuine, genuine match winner.
And I knew even in his early days, he was one of those players, a bit like Ballantyne, where they're right in your face, they're quite annoying. I always used to ask the question, would you have him in your team? And it's like, oh, and begrudgingly, they go, oh, yeah, I suppose. He's got better and better. And look,
that's a great call.
I actually didn't know, Troy, that Hawkins was All-Australian captain last year. That seems insane to me. One, he wasn't captain of his own club. How can he be the All-Australian captain?
They can tend to do that. Another text here before we get Foz on. The 1974 Socceroos side under Rally Razik. A bunch of part-timers who made the World Cup, Pele from Paraka. So it's 8223000 on the back of the Tillys, the Matildas. Mm. They are sweeping all before them as far as appeal and viewability. I mean, well over 6 million watched. Yeah. 6.5 million absolutely. Australians.
The Australians are going 12, 18. Along for the ride, and they're taking us on their back.
It's nearly 1 in 3.
Yeah.
Nearly 1 in 3, more than the AFL Grand Final, the number one watch show, all of that, and it's only going to get bigger and bigger and bigger. You saw Fed Square when Seven honed into it. It's just packed. Where's our Fed Square?
Ours is down Festival Plaza.
Yeah, it is now.
Do we have one as big as that?
Yeah. Not quite as big, but it's packed every night when there's the Aussies on.
Yep, so the quarterfinal will be 4:30 this Saturday versus the winner of tonight's game.
Correct. France and Morocco play off at Highmarsh Stadium at 8:30.
Correct.
So the winner of that plays Australia. And that'll line up pretty much with the Crows game against the Brisbane Lions at the Gabba. Pretty much the same time, they're across the river.
Yeah, exactly.
How do we feel about that?
Well, it's I suppose it's unpredictable because you don't know whether you're going to get through to those rounds. So it's hard to – and then try and avoid NRL – AFL timings, very difficult. And the Netball World Cup was in there as well. So,
what's your favourite national team? Here's another selection here. My favourite Aussie team, the women's cricket team. Roger. Mm. Well, gee, they do win a lot of things. I think the reason this one, and Timmy, you said it, is catching everyone's interest, is it is truly the world game. Yeah. So, I mean, everyone plays it.
Correct.
Everyone plays the great game. Let's go to Foz now. Craig Foster, welcome.
Yeah, hi, how are you guys? Great to talk to you.
Oh, my goodness, how impressive was that, Craig? That was, hey?
Oh, mate, it's so good, it's so good. The whole country's happy. You know, that's what the Matildas do. You know, when we watch them play, it's not just that they win. It's the way they conduct themselves, you know, the energy they show, you know, the aggression on the field, the fairness they bring to the game. I mean, look at Hayley Razzo. They call her Razzo Dazzle now. You know, she runs around, you know, she's... But you know what, if I come back as a footballer again, if I go back 30 years, I want to play like Hayley Razzo. You know, I just love her. They're just amazing, this group. Yeah.
What's impressed you the most? I think our coach has got the back half going well. What's it, our third clean sheet in 4 games? I'm impressed with that.
Yeah, the defence has really improved, and that's important. So you know, you saw what happened against Nigeria. Alana Kennedy has grown into the tournament. Claire Hunt has been absolutely amazing, and she's so phenomenal because she's just quiet. She doesn't say anything on the field. You know, she's just one of those real leaders. Everything's good. She's calm on the ball. So the centre of our defence is now really, really strong. Mackenzie Arnold's going well in goal. And then, of course, you've got the two number sixes in front who are just now just having an amazing tournament. Everyone's talking about Kyra and Katrina. That's good. And then you've got the two fullbacks. So, you know, you've got to obviously be able to score goals. But if you've got weak defence, you never win in a World Cup. You're certainly not even making the quarterfinal in a tournament of this quality. So they've been absolutely brilliant. Mm. And you know what, guys? The next game, and of course, there's three games to immortality for the Matildas.
Yep.
And this will be the toughest three games they've ever had in their lives.
I'm glad you mentioned Hayley Russo. I don't think she's been the Matildas player of the tournament so far. She just hasn't put a foot wrong in all the games that we've played. And it's that exactly that energy you're talking about. And she's getting rewarded now with scoring.
Yeah, against Canada, she was the game breaker, right? And then last night again, she scored a crucial goal. So she's always there. She's always ready to take people on. You know, the amount of work that Caitlin Ford and Hayley Russo got through last night in terms of defending, getting back, up and down, counter-attacking again is absolutely phenomenal. And it's a testament to the conditioning and the fitness of this group, which obviously they've got staff there who are partly responsible for that. But, you know, the fact that these guys are all now playing with the top clubs in the world, you know, Arsenal, Chelsea, you know, across with Lyon, with Ellie Carpenter, it just goes to show, you know, and that's important now because they've only got 4 days until the next game, and then if they get through, they've got 3 days and then 3 days. So very little recovery now between these last few games.
Hey, Mary Fowler, I know she's only a young player. Her skill level, just when she gets it, she doesn't waste it. And that 45-metre pass, I reckon it was, through defenders, left foot for Caitlin Ford to run onto, and Caitlin did a great job in finishing it off. And a great nutmeg goal. But Mary Fowler's pass, that was the highlight so far for me.
Oh, yeah, highlight of tournament, maybe. You know, and for, you know, people who understand the game and know the game, you know how difficult that pass is.
Yeah,
you know,
because
she's going backwards. Yeah, gone.
Ford didn't change stride. That's the art of it, isn't
unbelievable. It's unbelievable. The ball was the perfect direction. It was curling towards goal a little bit. She didn't need to change direction or stride. All she needed is one touch and finish. Like, that's a perfect pass. But that's a perfect pass over 10 metres.
Yeah. Right?
Now you're talking about over 50 metres, you know, in a round of 16 in the World Cup, when you're kind of facing backwards of just turn, and now you've got to see the pass and execute it. It's unbelievable. Like, it's a pass that would grace any field in the world at any time in any era of any player. That is the quality of that pass. It's unbelievable.
Mm. Sam Kerr, what are you doing from here, Foz? You keep the starting 11 to your starter. I'm glad she had a little squirt. The crowd went berserk at the 80th minute. Man, how good is she?
Oh, she's unbelievable. Like, when she came on, I mean, you could hear it probably in Melbourne, you know. It was just unbelievable. It was like one of those moments when all of Australia stood up. The stadium stood up, 75,000 people, but everyone's standing up at home. You know, it was just incredible. Shows how much she's captivated the nation. Mm. She is, you know, she is one of the finest athletes we've ever produced. She's at the very peak of the largest game in the world. If the girls do well and make the semi or even the final, you know, let's hope. You know, she could win the next Ballon d'Or for the number one player in the world. You know, you can't overstate how incredible that is for an Australian player to do that, right? But you know what? Even in that 15 minutes and only half fit, it was immediately evident the quality that she has.
Yeah.
You know, she was quicker. She turns immediately. Her touch is so brilliant. You know, her passing was a little bit off because she hasn't played for a couple of weeks. But, you know, just the dynamism, the will to win, you know, she wants to dominate. She got a turn, she goes past opponents, and okay, a shot went over the post, but in the next round, you know, that's on target. So it's difficult to know whether she'll start or not, but the thing is, I think it might depend on if it's France or Morocco.
Okay.
Right? If it's Morocco, I don't think she necessarily needs to, but if it's France, I think she probably will, because you're now looking at a different France to the one we played before the tournament. Mm. Like us, they're battle-hardened, they're fully fit now, they're over their jet lag, they only just got here.
Yeah.
The next three games are very serious, and I'm not sure, from the coach's perspective, I'm not sure that you want to take any risk of going behind.
Yeah.
Right? You need, and that's where the Matildas are good. Because we're good at counter-attack, if we get our noses in front, and we have in the last two games, then we're difficult to play because the opponent has to come at us and try and score. and then we're going to hit him again two or three times. If we go behind, it becomes much more difficult because now they're going to sit and we've got to come at them. So therefore, you know, I think that it's probably the best policy to use your absolute best team and try and dominate, get ahead, and just hold on like they did last night.
France and Morocco, 8:30 tonight. That's in Adelaide at Highmarshall Cross there at about 6 o'clock. Germany's out, Foz. USA is out. Brazil, Canada and Italy. We can win this whole damn thing, Foz. Mate, just close your eyes for a sec. You love this world game as we do.
Yeah.
Just close them for a second. Dare to dream.
Yeah, that's right. I'm glad you've said that. So I was going to ask you a question. Like, do you think Australia realises the magnitude of what this team is doing? And if they make a semi-final for the first time ever, what that actually means in the biggest game in the world, or if they make the final, and let's just dream for a moment. Like, you know, does Australia actually really get the difficulty of really achieving and actually winning a World Cup, whether it doesn't matter if it's the females or the males? What do you think?
Craig, I think now...
It's not lost on me.
They're being educated, and the numbers that are viewing this suggest that they are. And that's what I love about it. They're actually... I think the Matildas have taken everybody on this journey with them.
I think that's right.
Yeah, and they're the ones educating everybody.
That's true, because, you know, the Nigeria game knocked a few people around.
Yeah. But,
you know, Australia, we don't look at... You know, most Australians don't look at football overseas all the time, and they just come in the Socceroos and Matildas, right? And then we tend to have this feeling that we can win anything and that we should win. Mm. And then we get a bit surprised. People go, oh, geez, you know, we've got the round of 16. We've got Argentina with the Socceroos. Oh, geez, you know, we haven't gone that far, right?
Yeah.
But once you understand the difficulty of this game, the fact that all of the top 10 that we're playing against, and the other side of the draw has got, you know, four of the top 10. All of these countries are spending, you know, 50 times what we're spending. You know, they've been at it for much longer. They've had professional leagues for much longer. When you think about the fact that these Australian girls are taking on the world, you know, and have an actual real chance of winning a World Cup on home soil, like, that is so astounding that, you know, it's going to take over the country. Like, last night was 3.7 million. I think it was like over 6 million people watched it at some point, right? Okay, the next one's going to be another million. If they make the semi-final, it's going to blow all of the TVs up. And if these guys make the final, it's going to be... Nothing can touch it. This is unbelievable what they're doing.
Foz, love your passion, mate, for the world game. We love how you support us over here. Keep fighting the good fight, mate. I love what you do on and off the pitch, mate. Well done. Thanks for your time.
Too right. Go Matildas.
Go you, Tillies. Craig Foster there, former soccer himself and soccer broadcaster. He does
He's
a lot of great things around the world, which
Absolute
is great.
Ripper.
He is a ripper. Are we ready for this?
OTR Super Sprint tickets. We will do the quiz on the other side of this. Here's your traffic.
At Blair, got a road closed due to a fire. That's James Road between Old Blair Road and She Oak Road. Elizabeth, crash there, Main North Road near Yorktown Road. While at Hindmarsh, expect a few road closures this afternoon. That's due to the soccer. It's around Manton Street and kicks off around 5:30. Busy, Alice Road at South Road with cameras, Education Road, Happy Valley, and Gage Street at Firle. Guzmani Gomez's 10 under $10 menu. $3 tacos, free range chicken tacos, fries with chipotle mayo and more. This is value without compromise. GYG, Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
The 5AA Sports Show, Rowey and Timmy G. Each week on the 5AA Sports Show, Rowey and Timmy talk to star players from the Power. Thanks to One Solution. Protect and improve your business with One Solution, winner of the National Telstra Enterprise Customer Excellence Award.
If you've got to keep it cool, you need budget car and truck rentals, especially if you're in business. Budget Car and Truck Rentals have a fleet of refrigerated vans, trucks and cool rooms standing by to keep your business in business. Transporting or storing flowers, chocolate and all fresh produces. Keep it cool in a refrigerated van, truck or cool room from Budget Car and Truck Rentals. Oh, great for parties too. Call 13 27 27. That's 13 27 27.
What's the best thing about winter? Definitely the Bob Burns Blinds Winter Warmer Special. Get super cozy with up to 40% off. That's up to 40% off our entire range of curtains and blinds, including our energy efficient window coverings. With Bob Burns Blinds, you'll get that quality show home look, and you'll save money on energy bills by trapping the heat in your home. Get set for winter now with a Bob Burns Blinds Winter Warmer Special. Book your free measure and quote at bobburnsblinds.com.au.
In tough times, it's the simple things that make a big difference. Like $17 schnitzel days at the Albion, Birkenhead Tavern, Excelsior and the Lighthouse Wharf. We know the humble Schnitty can't fix all our problems, but we do know it'll put a smile on your dial. $17 schnitties Mondays, Tuesdays and Wednesdays at the Albion, Birkenhead Tavern, Excelsior and the Lighthouse Wharf. Making the world a better place. One schnitty at a time. Gotta start somewhere. You just know it's a Barrow hotel.
If you thought it was tricky to source a great deal on a new Volkswagen, think again. Mawson Lakes Volkswagen's demo clearance is on now. We've loaded up on a massive range of demo Volkswagens available for delivery right now. Loads of colours, loads of options, plus on-site finance options available. And remember, we offer next-day servicing too. So hurry. The Volkswagen demo clearance won't last. Mawson Lakes Volkswagen, Salisbury Highway, just a short drive from the city.
Hello, Frank Walker from National Tiles. National Tiles checked and locked prices guaranteed to save you more than 20% below market prices every day of the year. Here's proof of another range. Revival handmade looking caustic tiles, best market price $49.95. National Tiles checked and locked price $39.95. That's 20% saving. No, not on special. That's 20% saving every day of the year. Only at National Tiles.
Hi, Rory Sloan here for You Installer Kitchens. Are you planning a DIY renovation? Then visit the team at You Install It for the complete DIY kitchen solution. You Install It Kitchens cabinetry is custom size and pre-assembled, saving you time and money. Plus, Soulstone by Cosentino benchtops, Oliveri sinks and taps, and a large range of appliances by Fisher & Paykel and Haier. Visit one of the five locations, Modbury, Churchill Centre, Norwood, Glandore and Lonsdale. You Install It Kitchens, the complete DIY kitchen solution.
With more stores close to home and everyday low prices, great food lives at Foodland, the mighty South Aussies.
Rowie and Timmy G on the 5AA Sports Show.
10 minutes to 5, Campo coming up shortly. We have your chance to win a double pass to the 777 suite of the OTR Super Sprint. It's next Saturday at the Bend. We're going to be there on Friday. These are the best seats in the house at the Bend. Food and bev package for the day. Each ticket valued at a whopping $550. So, we have our Super Sprint quiz to get underway, and we have two contestants on the line.
Okay, hello Barbie from Plimpton.
Hello.
Is that your nickname or real name?
No, nickname.
Okay. Have you gone and seen the new movie, Barbie?
Very good.
$1 billion.
Very
tongue-in-cheek.
I loved it.
Okay. Well, Barbie from Plimpton, your buzzer is Win Cup. Give me one.
Win Cup. I don't know. What does he do? I've got a car. Does that help?
Barbie.
Oh, well.
Oh, God.
Oh, dear.
Barbie. Oh, dear. You just had a Barbie it's there. Barbie, your buzzer is Win Cup. Give me a Win Cup.
Win Cup.
Good girl, good Barbie. Mom. Hello, Gav.
Excellent.
Mate, if you don't win this, you're a peanut. Sorry, Barbie. You're acting like one. Gav, your buzzer is Ambrose.
Yeah.
Okay, give me an Ambrose.
Ambrose.
Barbie, give me a wink up.
Wink up.
Here's Timmy.
All right, question number one. In the famous Bathurst 1000 race, does the 1,000 stand for kilometres or laps?
Wink up.
Ambrose.
Oh, wink up was in first.
Kilometres.
Correct. Wait, wink up.
Well done. One to Barbie. Okay, question two. Who was the Sunday night headline entertainment at Adelaide 500 last year?
Ambrose.
The Killers.
The Killers. Correct. It's 1-1.
1-1.
Is it first of three, by the way?
Correct.
Yep.
Question three. Is the Adelaide 500 the first or last race on the Supercars calendar?
That was Ambrose.
Last.
It's 2-1, and I reckon Barbie knew that. Barbie, pull your finger out. Barbie, concentrate.
Okay, question four. Alan Hu was an inaugural inductee into the Supercars Hall of Fame in 19...
Ambrose.
Andy Moffat.
Correct.
Oh, Barbie, he got you.
3-1, but well done, Barbie, you knew them. She knew.
She did.
Oh, I did.
Yeah. Well, Barbie, you get squat for being last. Gav, well done.
Give us something. Movie ticket.
Gav.
Yes.
You just won.
Thank you.
Mate, over $1,000. Who's the snoozer in the background?
That's Mum.
Oh, oh Mum. And the dog's barking, Gav.
Mum's happy.
The dog loves it.
Oh, oh mate, that's over $1,000. You love the OTR awesome, Super mate. Sprint. Awesome. You're at the Duck's Gut seats.
Thank you.
Good on you, Gav. Well done.
Another chance to win
tomorrow.
The dog's
gone berserk. Yeah. Does Barbie get anything?
Sadly not. Try again tomorrow.
Okay. It's probably not the first nickname you'd... I mean, Barbie.
She might not have chosen it because most people's nicknames they don't choose.
Yeah, but if I think of Barbie, I think of somebody with a big shock of Farrah Fawcett hair.
Oh, right.
Blonde.
You're talking a 1970s yeah. Barbie doll. That's
blue
what
eyes.
Thinking.
Stereotypical yeah. Barbie
sort
doll.
Sort of like pasty white yeah. with those big lips.
Yeah.
We know what it looks like.
You know what I mean?
Yep.
And what there's other things, there's other features that I won't... But I'm going to go and see that Barbie movie. Everyone reckons it's good.
Well, they do. Yeah, they do. I didn't get an invite, but that's all right. My girls have already gone.
What do you mean an invite? You got
didn't give me an invite.
Go and see it yourself, Tim.
Well,
no, but I think you drive yourself to the
No, but I don't think it's for dudes.
Do you want to see me?
Oh, there's lots of blokes that have gone and seen it.
Okay.
Nah, I'm going to clip that and go to the atomic bomb one.
Oppenheimer, very good. Have seen it.
Yeah.
Is that good?
It's very
worth
seeing? 3 hours, though, if you're willing to sit okay. through 3 hours. Very good.
Yeah, I did.
Okay. Sorry, Barbie, we had a bit of fun with you, but you know what? If that's your nickname, fair dinkum.
No, that's not her fault. Like I said, sometimes in Australia, you don't
Barbie.
Get to pick those nicknames,
well,
but that's all right.
You can say, please don't call me that.
No, she loved it.
Do you like Juniper?
No, not really.
Yeah.
But I'm happy to run with it. I'm happy to run with it. Now, Craig Foster.
Juniper.
Craig Foster, you asked
yeah.
the question
yeah,
about do we start Sam Kerr in the next game
yes.
or don't we? So it's a big question. It's one that I'd thought about. And there's different answers. We want to go with Craig's first.
No. We'll hear from Ian Wright, though, who's in the country and, of course, very well known in Europe for a long time. He had his say yesterday when a journalist asked if whether it would disrupt the Matildas.
Is there a danger that she might disrupt things, or is she so world-class?
Are you serious?
Throw us straight in.
Are you serious? We're talking about the best number nine in the world. It doesn't matter, you know, with all due respect to whoever's playing up front. You know, Sam Kerr's fit, she's plays.
Well answered.
And look, he's right. And that's where I was coming from. That was the camp I was coming from. Because if you're going to go into this next one,
yeah.
which is, you know, basically a quarter final, you have to win it. And if you're playing somebody like France, top class, you've got to get that score on the board. And who do you do it with? Your best players. It's sort of like saying, oh, look, if, you know, for the Adelaide Crows, if Tex Walker's available, do you play him? Oh, I don't want to disrupt the forward line. I played well last week. Please. You're putting him in the forward line.
Oh, of course.
He's right. playing. So it's like Connor Rosie, oh, we don't want to, you know, interrupt the midfield because it went well last week. No. He's playing.
Yeah.
So that's the sort of mentality it has to go with it.
And Foz had an interesting one. I don't know whether we've got his.
Yes,
but, let's do it.
It's difficult to know where she'll start or not, but the thing is, I think it might depend on if it's France or Morocco.
Okay.
Right? If it's Morocco, I don't think she necessarily needs to. But if it's France, I think she probably will because you're now looking at a different France to the one we played before the tournament. Mm. Like us, they're battle-hardened, they're fully fit now, they're over their jet lag, they only just got here.
Yeah.
This is the next three games are very serious.
Odd starter.
You have
I'm
to,
leaning
I
that
think
way
you
now.
Have to, no. I think
what do you reckon Goofy will do?
That's a mystery.
Yeah.
I mean, he couldn't even spit out do or die the other day. I don't know what he was talking about. So
he cracks me up.
He does crack me up as well. Look, one thing I will say is he's very engaging on the sideline. And he's very enthusiastic. Yeah. So maybe the girls like that. So whatever he's doing, just keep doing
it. Keep doing it, Goofy. And before we go to the break, we've got Campo after the break.
He's raring to go.
Thanks to Unique Homestyle.
You know what he's had
foods.
Trouble doing? Is keeping the Unique Homestyle foods intact.
Well, our staff eat them all.
Hey, take them.
It's like...
We need to get on the Foodland live stream and have a look at those magnificent
like
things.
Cockroaches on sugar.
We'll speak to Caro on Thursday, and she reckons the AFL commissions canvassed Paddy Dangerfield to join it.
Well, this is an extraordinary story in my view that Patrick Dangerfield, currently the chairman of the AFL Players Association and the Geelong captain, has been approached by Gillon McLachlan to think about taking a role on the commission while still playing.
While playing.
That's the amazing part of the story. My understanding is that Patrick has spoken also briefly with Richard Goyder, the chairman. No decision has been made, but he has not backed the job yet. Unless there's something we don't know, and Geelong certainly don't believe to be the case that Patrick is retiring at the end of the year, I think it would be not only a radical break from tradition, but pretty much against the current charter of the commission, which is that you have to be independent now.
Well, an impressive individual, Paddy, but what I'll say about this, Paddy's only ever lived in the AFL bubble. I want people on that commission that have ran a business, been in a business, had the highs and lows of a business, know how to run a business, because this is a business, mm-hmm. and can add to that. You know, nothing against Paddy, but what's he going to add to that commission?
I just think also it's right back to that independence that we spoke about. I think you've got to do exactly what you're saying. If he comes away from the game and goes and does other things and then comes back, fair enough. While you're playing?
I wouldn't question his independence because he's been the chair of the AFLPA. He is a smart kid, but goodness me.
Yeah.
No,
it's a no from me.
Yeah, it's a no from me.
You can have your say as well. 8223 0000. Campo is going to join us next after the 5 o'clock news.
Rowie and Timmy G on the 5AA Sports Show.
Go Vita, your local health food shops. Over 30 years health and wellness experience and over 300 natural health practitioners specialising in you.
Hi, I'm Sue from Go Vita Semaphore. This month, help support your immune system with NutriVital 100% pure vitamin C powders. Simply mix with water or juice. You'll save 40% with our handy resealable pouch today. Always read the label and follow directions for use.
Go Vita, Colonnades, Fairview Green, Marion, Mount Barker, Manopara, Semaphore and Tanunda.
New Zealand, spectacular, safe and friendly. The perfect destination for a magical getaway. Right now, Holiday Wonders Mitcham have an exclusive 17-day fully inclusive package. It's our best deal ever. Save up to $980 per couple. Fly direct from Adelaide with Air New Zealand, touring North and South Islands with meals, accommodation and so much included, with more highlights than any comparable New Zealand holiday. Call now or visit holidaywonders.com.au. Holiday Wonders, Belair Road, Mitcham.
Just make sure you're TJM equipped. This beautiful country we've got, you know, you want to be able to do it in real style, and TJM will be able to make you do that. TJM SA, they've been around for 10 years, since 1990. Italo and his magnificent team, sponsored Ed McHenry, community-minded. Yeah. Not only have they got the best gear, they've got the best price and the best service. I love TJM SA.
And the thing about that, it's about the family. It's Italo, his family. The people that work in there are like family. And, you know, for 10 years they've been doing it since purchasing it in 2012. But they just keep helping people who go off-road. And that's what you got to be, TJM equipped. Safety and comfort are always priority. They've got bull bars, suspensions, snorkels, camping gear, roof racks, driving lights. They've got it all.
They have
it all.
Get
a packet of Chewies off him.
You've got to check out the newly renovated showroom as well. The brand new display and products at Australia's number one, that's it, TJM store. It's in Nailsworth. As we said, Ned McHenry's fishing show at 6:30, they tonight. Sponsor it. So do it. Do this. Visit TJM in Nailsworth and Clovelly Park, the major sponsor of Ned McHenry. Oh, goodness me, be listening to this. TJM equipped.
Online, on DAB Digital Radio, and on 1395 AM. Talking Adelaide. This is Adelaide's 5AA.
Clear tonight, showers developing tomorrow and 20. With the 5 o'clock news, I'm Mel Usher.
Get 10-year warranty and 10 years capped price servicing on the new Mitsubishi Outlander at Agostino Mitsubishi.
Raylene Polymiades is preparing to spend her first night with her son after being granted bail. The 62-year-old from Craigmore was arrested last month and charged with two counts of murder over the poisoning of her two elderly parents. Brenda Anderson died in 2022 and Linton Anderson in 2023. She was freed today after a court ruled on the treatment of her diabetes if she remained in custody. Ms. Polymiades claimed the condition was being mismanaged. There'll be another court appearance later in the year. Households are continuing to slow their spending as the rising cost of living bites into family budgets. Michael Packey reports.
Latest data by the Bureau of Statistics shows spending increased 1.8% for the year to June, but this is half the May reading. People are spending more on essentials like food and health and cutting back on discretionary items. The opposition's Angus Taylor says it's bad for families and businesses.
These are the tough choices that we're seeing Australians have to make to make ends meet.
Treasurer Jim Chalmers concedes some people are doing it tough, but help is on offer.
The Albanese government's number one priority is rolling out billions of dollars in cost of living assistance.
Separate data by the ANZ shows a 3-point drop in consumer confidence over the past week, defying the Reserve Bank's decision to keep interest rates on hold.
Victorian Premier Daniel Andrews says it's too soon to consider a campaign warning of the dangers of deathcap mushrooms. Three people have died and a fourth person, a 68-year-old man, continues to fight for life in hospital after eating the poisonous mushrooms. The woman who prepared the meal has denied she's responsible for the deaths. The Premier says the exact cause of death is yet to be determined.
Send our deepest sympathies to all of those involved. This will be very challenging for them. Let's wait and see what comes out of that coronial inquiry and any other inquiries that might be made. And then I think Victorians can rest assured that we will take any of those findings, any learnings from that, very seriously.
Labor has agreed to a major policy shift on Israel, claiming the West Bank and Gaza settlements are illegal under international law. The Prime Minister is hoping the move will quell a backlash over the party's stance on Palestine. Foreign Minister Penny Wong telling Parliament the government consulted widely before making the change.
The Australian government is strengthening its opposition to settlements by affirming they are illegal under international law and a significant obstacle to peace.
The opposition has slammed the government's position, arguing it's a backroom deal to appease Labor's power brokers. Sinead O'Connor's funeral will take place tonight, our time. The singer died last month, aged 56. Fans have been invited to line the route the cortege will take through the seaside town of Bray in Ireland. ITV's Stuart Robson is there.
Sinead O'Connor called Bray and County Wicklow home for 15 years. At her former house, laurel tributes and messages of sympathy have been left. Also, just within the last few days, a large sign has been emblazoned on a cliff top just a few hundred yards away. This morning, of course, those heartfelt messages that have been seen on the cliff top and on this street will translate into thousands of people lining this road to say goodbye.
Now turning to 5AA Sport.
Collect the newest 2023 AFL footy cards available at Sports Card World, Regent Arcade.
AFL retirements are in the spotlight today. Essendon ruckman Andrew Phillips will call time on his career at the end of the season. He's played 79 senior games across 12 seasons for the Bombers, Blues and Giants. Eagles captain Luke Shuey has announced he'll retire at season's end, citing injuries as a key factor in the decision. The 33-year-old says it's been a tough decision to make, but believes the time is right to step away from the game.
To go around again next year, I wouldn't be able to offer my best version as a player and as a teammate, and I didn't want to leave on that note and do that to our footy club and our fans. So it feels so right, and I feel 10 kilos lighter sitting here now. So, yeah, I've made the right decision.
And North Melbourne's Ben Cunnington will play his final game this weekend. Australia's surge into the World Cup quarterfinals is turning heads. England and Arsenal great Ian Wright says the Matildas have to be considered genuine threats to lift the trophy.
I don't know what more to say about the capabilities of the Australian side, and now that Sam Kerr's back, the way they're playing, the way the crowd are obviously so much behind them, you have to say that they're one of the favourites to win the tournament.
Next up, they'll play the winner of tonight's France-Morocco game being played at Hindmarsh. Now checking 5AA traffic.
Quite a few collisions to look out from the drive home. One at Ascot Park, Doors Road near Railway Terrace. Another one at Mile End, Henleybees Road near South Road. Heavy delays, find another way if you can. And Blair got a road closed due to a fire. That's James Road closed between Old Blair Road and She Oak Road. Busy, Aylifs Road at South Road with cameras, Grand Junction Road, Hope Valley and Hub Drive at Aberfoyle Park. Booking a group holiday is no joke, but Flight Centre's group travel experts will turn it into a breeze. Call a Flight Centre group travel expert on 1300 927 587. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Now the 5AA forecast.
Get the Toyota forklift advantage. Visit toyotamaterialhandling.com.au.
Clear tonight, dropping to 8. Showers developing tomorrow, 20. Thursday, a shower or two, 15. 15 again on Friday. Right now, it's 17 degrees. Now let's hear what's happening on 9 News tonight.
I'm Kate Collins. Tonight, police rescue two South Australian children after a global sting that left FBI agents dead. The parents of a young hit-run victim give harrowing evidence as their son's accused killer stands trial. A joyride ends in drama for a carjacker on the run, and a suspected Russian spy arrested over a plot to kill Ukraine's president. See the full story live on 9 News at 6 p.m. and on 9 Now.
The high-tech home of tomorrow has a new name. It's not Siri or Alexa. It goes by the name Jim. Add data, security and complete connectivity to your home with Jim's antennas and security. Ask Jim how security cameras and motion sensors can give you peace of mind and keep an eye on your house, yard, cars and sheds. Jim can do top brand 4 camera systems from just $1,595. For a high-tech home, just ask Jim. Hey Jim, gymsantennasandsecurity.com.au.
Ready? Let's push it. With up to 5.5% interest available on an ING savings account for eligible customers. Your hard-earned cash can work even harder for you. Make bank on your moolah with an ING savings account. Now, let's give your savings a run for its money. Come on, do it.
Rate includes additional variable rate of 4.95% on eligible balances up to 100k. General advice only. CT&Cs at ing.com.au. ING ABN 24000893292. AFSL 229823.
What are they doing up there? Tap dancing? Okay, they are actually tap dancing.
Just shut up.
Oh, yeah. KFC are doing $8 boxes. Oh, shut up and take my money.
Not everywhere and not forever. Pick up only through KFC app and web.
With more stores close to home and everyday low prices, great food lives at Foodland, the mighty South Aussies.
Rowie and Timmy G on the 5AA Sports Show.
8 minutes after five on your Tuesday evening. Coming up this hour, the Australian Cricket Chairman of Selectors, George Bailey, a local Adelaide umpire of 50 years. He's 77. Barry Lewis. And he's still running around. An amazing story. Plus another double to the Port Adelaide locker room to give away. But it's time now to welcome in to Coach's Corner, Scotty Camporeale, for Unique Homestyle Foods, proudly baking for hundreds of South Australian businesses for 35 years. It is greatness in the making.
Here he comes again, Camporeale.
Camporeale on the board. Arches his back. Snapshot by Camporeale.
1-16. Coach's Corner with Campo.
Yeah, we love that. Campo, welcome.
Thanks, guys. Good to be here again.
Got the donuts in front of you on the Foodland live stream.
They smell good, don't they?
Yeah. Hang on, mate. I heard you had a bit of a battle out there.
Yeah.
With the staff. They're ripping it apart.
We're getting raided.
Well, once you put them on the communal breakfast bench, good luck.
Well, I think there was like over a dozen donuts and there was lots of pastries. And what did you say was left? Two pasties.
Well, that's all that's left from the donuts. Wow. And the box is quite big, as you know. Yeah. And the pasties, I reckon there's two pasties in a pile for Leith a little bit later on.
Now, Campo, are you getting swept up with Tilly fever like us?
I really enjoyed the game last night. I did. I'd watched a little bit of it before the first couple of games, but I was really intrigued in this one, obviously, as it gets a bit closer. But, geez, they played well. I thought early they looked a little bit under the pump. It looked like Denmark, they were
attacking.
They missed one or two that you thought maybe
one
might
went
have
into
been
the keeper's leg and bounced out. Yeah.
But I love Fowler's through ball.
That was magnificent. Ooh. That was the highlight of the tournament.
It was actually quite funny because I was coaching down at Pulteney and we're talking about kicking to advantage.
Yes.
Like at training, you know, about where you should put the ball. That was centimetre perfect to use, you know, Dennis Cometti's line, but it was brilliant. Like, she did not break stride in terms of that. That was phenomenal, but it was great. It was great to see him win.
It is a sport that unites all, doesn't it? Because I said at the opener, my whole family sat there. I can't remember the last time we all sat in a lounge and watched an Australian team play.
No, we did as well, I must admit. Yeah, but the two boys, my daughter was out, but and Ali as well, and she's a huge sport lover.
Let's get on to the footy, because I know you got some words on Port's last four losses, but the Crows, I thought, a very mature win.
Yeah, no, they were good. I mean, as we've called Rowie throughout the year, when they have that weight and numbers performance, like there was no huge. There was a couple of standards. I thought Hinge was great. I thought Darcy Fogarty was great, and I thought Matt Crouch, and they were the ones we gave the votes to in terms of. But you could have easily put another five or six in there. Some apologies, you know. So when they play that way, you don't need the superstar, you know, 40 possessions and the reliability of that, but. Yeah, it was. It was a step in the right direction. They won inside the contest. You know, they beat them on the outside again. And their turnover game's well and truly intact, both offensively and defensively, which is going to need to be against Brisbane up there.
An unheralded back six. They'll be tested this week.
Yeah. I did.
Borlay on debut.
Well, I did write a few names down. You sit there and go. Well, Danaher, Hipwood, Gunston, Rayner, Cameron and Bailey. Ooh. That's a real danger. Yeah. And don't forget, last time I went back and had a look. They had 66 inside 50s, Brisbane, and couldn't get it done.
Crows beat them round 11.
They kicked 1-9 in the third quarter, Brisbane. So they'd want to tidy up that Adelaide and not allow them to get in that inside 50 against a somewhat inexperienced backline. But it was interesting that, and we reflected a little bit, Roy, on, you know, the, I guess, the continuity of that back six. it was great the fact that those guys would have played a lot of sample footy together.
They were.
So they probably weren't overawed in terms of looking around and going, there's Tom Duday. I've never played with Tom Duday. Or, there's Nick Murray. I've never played with Nick Murray other than perhaps in a bit of match sim. But to see those guys gel together, they did it really well.
The rise and rise of Matt Crouch, no surprise to you. That's what an opportunity presents, and he'd taken it with both hands.
Oh, that's what you love to see, and take Matt out of it. Anyone that gets an opportunity and they grab it, after a long stint, either through injury or not being able to get in because of, team selection or the team's going that well that you can't get in. But he was, once again, at his absolute best again.
And now Port Adelaide, they said a loss with merit, and it's still a loss.
Mm.
And I had a look at it. A lot of the last quarter seems to be an issue, but you reckon there's other issues that perhaps Port have got?
Yeah, well, I just went back and had a look over there last month because, one or two weeks can be an anomaly in terms of some of the stuff that goes on. But 4 weeks, you can get a bit of a good look as to
good
where
sample size.
Yeah, where they sit. So they're 18th for points against in the last month. That's not a great stat.
No.
Right? So you're the worst team in the country. Well, you're getting scored against.
Chibby, bang, he just went bang. So, 18th.
So that's the worst. That's probably they're 16th from turnover score. So their turnover game's in not great shape. Mm-hmm. We've known this year that they've scored heavily from stoppage. That's been a real strength of theirs. They're 14th in the last month from there. Their clearance differential was 12th the last month. So before that, I think they were top two or top three around there. And then that forward half game where they got that going.
Yeah.
They're 18th for rebound 50, so they're not moving the ball out of their back 50 with any fluency at all when they turn it over in their back half.
And Houston was well held on the weekend.
Yep. 18th for frees against, and I know you guys have already brought that up again. They're 18th for marks, so they're now not marking the ball either. So even though they had a 19 marks inside 50, they're just not marking the ball either or keeping the ball off the opposition. And their disposable efficiency is 18th at 70% the last month, whereas before that's around that 75. So 5% is a fairly big drop-off. And their ground ball game is still suspect for mine. So, yes, we can talk about personnel coming in and out, and that has an influence on some of those numbers, no doubt. But if you look at the pure raw numbers and what they need to improve on, they need to get some of those things back in track.
Quite significant stats, those ones, aren't they? The two winning a game week in, week out. But I was just saying on Monday that I've just had a look at each of the thirds of Port Adelaide, and there's key injuries in each of those every week, and there's no continuity back to your point about Adelaide's defence that Port have been able to get. And it seemed to me like I thought their three young midfielders in Rosie Butters and Horn Francis were outstanding with a three-game ruckman. I would hate to think what they would do if they had somebody dropping it down their throat at ease.
Yeah, well, it's interesting because I mean we always have this argument around what's important a is a ruckman worth, and as we know, sometimes you can win hitouts and maybe hitouts, but sometimes it's easier to actually just worry about what the opposition are doing. So you're actually less reactive or less proactive around there based on . To be fair, Port Adelaide have been really strong in that area all year. Yeah. So it's really only been the last probably 3 or 4 weeks that they haven't. But those three players are obviously pivotal in their form line.
Big week this week.
You need a few more soldiers.
There was a bit in the paper today about it, but the Port Adelaide Footy Club have asked for umpire clarity on the one umpire that paid 15 free kicks against them. Nathan Buckley was asked, actually, on SEN whether he ever did it as a player. As a coach.
No, my energies were always internal with the players. The director of footy would call on occasions, or the operations guy would call on occasions. But I never felt like that I was compelled. I had no question in the integrity of the umpiring department. I've had never had any question that of how hard a job it is.
He's a better man than me.
It's an interesting one. I always feel like you'll never win that battle. That's probably my viewpoint on it. But what's yours?
Yeah, no, you're never going to win it. And I know when I was senior assistant, there would be, I'd have on the old sports code line, you'd have some, ones on there. You're there going, geez, I just wouldn't mind some clarification around that, because often the players come in and they're a little bit confused as well.
What did I do wrong?
Yeah, and the AFL are really good in terms of they'd send out packages you know, throughout the year, if there was something that may have come up from three or four different clubs, so they would send out those sort of packages. But yeah, you're on a bit of a hiding to nothing. I mean, it's all after the fact and you can't do anything about it. But the ones that used to irritate me were the ones where, you know, like it'd be a stoppage inside 40 and everyone would be holding, and then there'd be one umpire 50 metres away and he'd just ping one from nowhere and you're sitting there going, well, you could have paid any other...
I could show you play. Eight.
Yeah. And so that's where the frustration comes in. But, you know, I'm probably a bit like Bucks. You never... You got plenty of other things to do. And if you're worrying about the umpires are costing you a game, that's probably the, you know, 16th thing on the list.
But maybe that's the problem. All of you are like Bucks and you that never complain. How are they going to get better if they don't get any good, honest feedback?
Challenged.
They need me.
Well, I think they do.
I'll give them one right between their bloody eyes.
Yeah, well, I think they do get feedback. I mean, clearly they've got umpire directors and stuff that watch them and give them feedback. But it's
they're
not
a protected species, I think.
Yeah, well, I mean, I think part of it is we've got to understand that we're trying to get these people to... involved in the game, because unfortunately if they don't do their job we don't have a game, so we actually have to try and I guess maximize these guys. And part of it is still, you know, why won't the AFL make these guys full-time, you know? So that's part of it as well.
Sad reality is we're going to interview a bloke tonight who's 77 years old, still umpiring because of that very point.
But you know what? I keep hearing that, and I say to myself, it's like a bucket of water. You'll find someone. It'll find its level. Get rid of that one. He's no good. Someone will sit in there. They get about 10 grand a game.
Yeah, well, I mean, the money is one thing, but, you know, once again, it's a huge commitment for a lot of these guys as well. They're semi-part-time, so most of these guys are, you know, working full-time jobs, and a bit like the sample guys. And then, you know, they're travelling interstate, you know, they're getting scrutinised heavily. So I'm sort of 50-50. I know where your frustration is, Roy, and don't... I've whacked a few phones, don't worry, in the coach's box and at home at my place when I'm doing a review. So, but ultimately, you've got more to worry about than that.
Fair enough.
It's 19 minutes after 5. Campo's here for Unique Homestyle Foods. We'll come back with more on the other side. Here's your traffic.
Got a few collisions to look out for on the drive home. One at Ascot Park, Doors Road near Railway Terrace. Another one at Mile End, Henley Beach Road near South Road. Heavy delays, find another way if you can. And Blair got a road closed due to a fire. That's James Road closed between Old Blair Road and She Oak Road. Busy, Aylifs Road at South Road with cameras, Grand Junction Road, Hope Valley, and Hub Drive at Aberfoyle Park. Booking a group holiday is no joke, but Flight Centre's group travel experts will turn it into a breeze. Call a Flight Centre group travel expert on 1300 927 587. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
The 5AA Sports Show with Rowan and Timmy G. Join David and Will each week on the 5AA Breakfast Show as they speak to power excitement machine Orazio Fantasia. Orazio! Thanks to Foodland. With more stores close to home and everyday low prices, great food lives at Foodland, the mighty South Aussies.
Time to find out what's making news in Channel 7 Newsroom as we welcome Rosanna Mangiarelli to the show. And Rosanna, a sensational development in court.
Yeah, there has been, Tim, and it happened not that long ago. A Craigmore woman accused of murdering both her elderly parents with fatal insulin overdoses has actually been granted bail. So released from Northfield, free to go home. We'll have the very latest developments on that story. Also, Adelaide's new plan to curb boozy violence. So alcoholic shots they want banned after 2 a.m. and why it's not gone down well with the hotel industry. The staggering number of scam texts and calls which telcos have blocked this year, and of course exclusive access to the Matilda's magical victory last night, of course powering into the World Cup quarterfinals, and now even calls for a public holiday to celebrate their success. Wouldn't that be nice? It's going to National Cabinet, so serious stuff there.
Unbelievable stuff,
isn't it? Just
Anyway, mate, thanks for all that and all the team at Channel 7. There's only one choice, 7 News tonight at 6.
Need a forklift? Don't just get a forklift, get a Toyota forklift. Toyota is the world's number one forklift brand, with a great range of pallet jacks, walkie stackers and reach forklifts, right up to their leading Toyota counterbalance forklifts. Legendary reliability and safety, with cleaner, greener electric options, Toyota can tailor the right forklift solution for you. It's all part of the Toyota forklift advantage. For more, visit toyotamaterialhandling.com.au.
Get a Toyota forklift.
If you need to fix your pipes, call Precise.
Call Precise.
If you
your toilet's blocking up, call Precise.
Call Precise.
If your lights aren't turning on, or your hot water is gone, or a plumber or an electrician, call Precise.
Precise.
Precise Plumbing and Electrical. Call 1300 700 200. That's 1300 700 200. Precise Plumbing and Electrical. Local and experienced trade specialists.
Or a plumber or an electrician, call Precise.
Call Precise.
G'day everyone, Cornsy here. Now, I know a great team and I see one, and the South Australian hydraulic team I rate the highest is BL Shipway. I've known them for a long time. David Shipway is one of the best blokes you'll ever meet. BL Shipway, they've been looking after your hydraulic and pneumatic needs since 1953 with brands like Ryco, Rexroth, Enerpac, Hydac, Oilpath, EasyFit and many more. And if you can't get to them, they'll send a Ryco 24/7 van to you anytime, anywhere. blshipway.com.au, a South Australian team you can count on.
Get a read on a world of content with The Advertiser. One subscription that supercharges your news and entertainment experience. Access everything from breaking news to cost of living, sport and more. Search The Advertiser offer today. We're for you.
Hello, I'm Lynn Andrews. For over 50 years, the team at Lynn Andrews Real Estate have made it easy to manage residential and commercial property. Whether you own a single residential home or multiple commercial properties, our passion for property investment means we have a great deal of knowledge to share. How to invest safely and properly. Matching the right tenant with the right property every time. We're here to help. Visit lynandrews.com.au.
With more stores close to home and everyday low prices, great food lives at Foodland, the mighty South Aussies.
Rowan and Timmy G on the 5AA Sports Show.
24 minutes after 5, you can jump on the Foodland live stream. We're on Facebook and YouTube. Campo's here, all thanks to Unique Homestyle Foods.
Yeah, they got a text. He goes, geez, that's funny. Buckley coach Collingwood, he would have never had to complain to the umpires about that. Now, Campo, you've done a lot of work on the both clubs, where the free kicks are played, in what zones, and you've got some numbers.
Yeah, well, it's interesting. I mean, if you look at Port Adelaide, we know they're the number one free kick against in the competition. So they've given up 37 goals from free kicks. That's a fair bit. And Adelaide, on the flip side, they're the second most. They've given up 28. So the two Adelaide teams. So, I mean, it's as we know, it's hard enough to score, let alone giving away. Now, and that's all part. And some of it, and I'll finish or I'll preface some of this stuff with, there's two elements when you, I guess, look at free kicks. One, is it technique or is it intent?
Okay.
So they're the two things you've got to look at, you know, when you break some of these down. Because, once again, you're talking about a cross-section of players in terms of where, I guess, their maturity is, their skill level, their understanding of the game.
Position play?
All that stuff. Yeah, exactly.
So Horn Francis, the number one free kicks against, his is intent and technique.
Well, potentially.
He's way more free kicks than
any player. But sometimes intent is the first thing, because you can be sloppy with your technique based on your intent. So whereas sometimes when you're in a one-on-one, you might just grip and grab someone. That's more technique. So there's a balance in some of that, depending when, as we just said, in terms of the player, and they're all different. Yeah. They're all different. So that's part of it. But if you look at it, if you break it down, so Port Adelaide have had the most free kicks against in ruck contest. So if you look across the year, they haven't had a lot of Lysette, an experienced player, maybe playing undersized ruckman or younger ruckman.
Yep.
So sometimes with Finlayson and
loose front spot.
Yeah, so some of those things. So that hurts. They've given away the third most tackling. So that's intent and can be a little bit around
technique.
Intent as well. Yep. And they've given away the most in their marking contest, which is, that's for me, that's probably more technique than intent. So that can be, you know, all over the ground. That can be defenders trying to mark the ball, could be forwards giving away free kicks, or midfield, you know, through between the arms.
So what third are they giving away the most frees for Port?
So Port are giving away, so they're giving away the sixth most in forward 50, they're giving away the most through the middle of the ground, and they're giving away the fourth most inside their D50. So if you break that down, I mean, you're giving, and what the free kicks and why it is important, why we understand it, you're giving the ball straight back to the opposition with no pressure. So you're not actually trying to cause a turnover or team defense. And when you get to turn those over, you can attack off the back of those. But if you're giving them back, so
that's a stop play. Here's the ball.
Yeah, and if for Port, for example, if you're giving them away in the midfield, that's only one kick back inside your opposition's forward 50. Yeah. So now you're trying to defend and score out of your back 50. So there's an element of that as well. So
how do Adelaide compare in those?
Well, Adelaide, they give away the most free kicks inside their forward 50.
Wow.
Yeah, which is what I found quite interesting. They're third through the midfield and seven in their D50. So it's across...
Not too bad.
Yeah, it's well, I mean, it's still giving the ball back, but, you know, in terms of where they are and where they sit, you know, particularly Port, you know, they're, if they're vying for top four, they'd want to tidy that up going into a final series, I would have thought.
Mm. Yeah. So the Crows and Port are 1 and 2
yep.
for freeze against
yep.
in an 18-team comp.
Yep.
Oh, you give me a spill. You know what? I could have guessed that.
Their goals, too.
Without even, yeah. Mm. Without even knowing that stat, I would have guessed that.
Yeah, that's a nasty one. Interesting, unique homestyle foods text here. It says, Confucius said 5,000 years ago, he who blame umpires isn't looking hard enough in the mirror. Oh, there you go. Do you think that these sort of stats do help a coaching group, though, to say, okay, we actually probably need to look at our technique in this area?
Absolutely.
And 'cause when you mentioned about forwards, or about marking, I actually see Port's forwards behind a lot.
Mm.
And that's where I think that they might be giving away free kicks because of that.
Yeah, and absolutely. I mean, that's a tool for a coach. If you're sitting there going, well, if we're giving away the most marking free kicks in the competition, we need
get
to do
in front.
Something. We need to do something about it. Mm. Now, but then work back from there. Is it delivery? Is it the way we're kicking the ball inside forward 50? Are we not giving our forwards an opportunity? Mm. So there's those things as a coach that you drill down into and go, we need to tidy that up because, you know, you don't want to be, you know, I guess you still want to play on the line and on the cusp because you need to, but you don't want to be the most. You probably want to be 9th or 10th, so you're getting both ends of the bargain.
Okay. One last one here. This is for you, Campo, the unique homestyle food text line. Hey, Campo, no use asking Rowie what he thinks of the Crows list management. That's Neil from Encounter Bay. Neil, what are you saying? You big whale head.
Okay.
Whales, mate.
Well,
the whale's in, is it? Whale season? Neil, you big bloody southern right whale.
Well, we love Campo coming in. It is all thanks to Unique Homestyle Foods. They've been proudly baking for hundreds of South Australian businesses, large and small, for 35 years. Hustlers in the baking industry.
Yeah.
Tell you what, can't hang on to the product here. It goes straight out the door. Visit uniquehomestylefoods.com.au.
We're tucking into some donuts during the 5:30 headlines. George Bailey to join us next.
The 5AA Sports Show, Rowie and Timmy G. This is Adelaide's 5AA.
Good evening, Mel Usher with the latest news headlines. Australian households are continuing to scale back their spending, according to new figures. The controversial 3 a.m. lockout laws in our city are here to stay. American filmmaker William Friedkin, who gave us The Exorcist, has died at the age of 87. And in sport, North Melbourne's Ben Cunnington will play his final AFL game this weekend after announcing his retirement. Now checking 5AA traffic.
At St Clair, there's a crash, Cheltenham Parade near the rail crossing. Ascot Park, another collision there, Dawes Road near Railway Terrace, and another smash slowing things up at Broadview, Hampstead Road near Muller Road. Busy South Road at Edwardstown with cameras, Majors Road O'Halloran Hill and Langman Grove at Felixstowe. Make tonight's Taco Tuesday even better with delicious pork mince. It's Maravilloso and all your Mexican favourites. Find easy recipes at pork.com.au and get some pork on your fork. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
The 5AA forecast, clear tonight down to 8, showers developing tomorrow and 20. Right now it's 16 degrees. We'll have more news at 6 and as it happens on 5AA.
5AA Breakfast.
A massive and notoriously mischievous black bear has been captured after more than a year on the run that has allegedly broken into 21 homes in the Lake Tahoe area.
Informing Adelaide.
When's the justice system going to start taking things like this seriously?
Well, this story is fantastic because they did DNA samples on the crime scenes and found that there were at least two other bears who had been involved.
What, from their paw prints?
6 a.m. weekdays on 5AA.
To celebrate 70 years in solar, Solar Heart is giving you the chance to win a Tesla Model 3 electric vehicle worth up to $70,000. Simply buy a Solar Heart solar power system, Solar Heart water heater, heat pump or home battery and enter for your chance to win. Get smart. Get Solar Heart. Terms and conditions apply. Visit solarheart.com.au for details. Open to AU residents 18 plus. Ends 30th of September 2023. SA permit T23/871.
Folks travel far and wide to meet Trev from Rollerco.
G'day, is Trev around?
Oh, sorry, mate, he's with a customer right now.
Trev's always eager to please. Just pat him on the belly and he'll do anything for you. Oh, yes, Trev said you can order your sliding door or window parts online and he'll organise delivery to your door. Rollerco.com.au. They'll get you rolling. Hmm? No, I'm not patting you on the belly. Oh, all right.
I'm here at Chery Glen Osmond to take a test drive of the car that everyone is raving about, the Chery Emota 5. Oh, these seats are so comfortable and the state-of-the-art tech is worthy of a car three times its price. And almost every function of the vehicle can be controlled by voice. Chery, it's a bit cold.
Got it. Increasing the temperature in all areas to 22.0 degrees.
Book yourself a test drive of this incredible Emota 5 from 33k drive away. Visit gocherry.com.au.
Experience the magic of Europe with Bunnick Tours and Phil Hoffman Travel. Discover the dazzling jewels of Dalmatia, the rich cultural tapestries of Spain, Portugal and Morocco, or the charms of southern Italy, Sicily and Malta on a small group tour with a maximum of 20 guests, unique local experiences and flights included. See more, experience more and enjoy more with Bunnick Tours. Contact Phil Hoffman Travel or visit pht.com.au.
Here at 5AA, we're all about supporting local. Circare Clinical Research Alliance in Adelaide is looking for people who experience migraines and headaches for a clinical trial. Visit painmedsa.com and click research today.
Did you know that white lilies are one of the most popular type of funeral flowers? Representing peace, grace and dignity, and a popular choice for a respectful, dignified service that doesn't cost the earth? simplicityfunerals.com.au.
With more stores close to home and everyday low prices, great food lives at Foodland, the mighty South Aussies.
Rowie and Timmy G on the 5AA Sports Show.
26 minutes to 6. We're going to cross shortly to Highmarsh Stadium. The crowd is filing in outside the ground for the FIFA Women's World Cup match between France and Morocco. The winner will take on our Matildas. And stay listening, Port fans. Another chance for you to win Port locker room tickets. That is not too far away.
Well, Rowie, the ICC 2023 World Cup is coming up. Yes. It's going to be in India, but we've got to play a few games in between. So we've got a little tour of South Africa, and then we're going to go to India to talk about it. The chairman of selectors, George Bailey. Gee, George, I was going to say, you old enough to be remembered as, you know, playing cricket in the summer and footy in the winter. That these blokes wouldn't have any chance of that.
Yeah, no, and even for, I think for domestic players now, there's so many franchise opportunities and opportunities overseas. It's incredible how many of the domestic players have been overseas at some point this winter.
Mate, good news for us here in SA. Our own Spencer Johnson's made the Australian T20 squad for the South African tour. That's awesome.
Yeah, really excited for Spencer. Had a fantastic year in both the Big Bash and at the back end for South Australia. We actually really like his skill set across all three formats. And I think for him, you know, particularly speaking to the guys internally at South Australia, they've always been confident that the talent's been there, but he just hasn't been able to get a run at it from an injury perspective. So great to see him cap off the back of last year and play some really good cricket. Again, he's one who has spent a little bit of time overseas in the winter and sticking along quite nicely. So excited to unleash him in the T20s and go from there.
Yeah, well done. Mitch Marsh is named as captain in that. The only test player in there of note is Steve Smith, and why wouldn't he be? The rest, Travis Head's another one. Are you just having a look with that squad? There's a lot of new names there, George.
There is, yeah. No, well, we are having a look, but I think one of the things we're really aware of in the lead-up to the T20 World Cup, we've got these three games in South Africa. There's five T20s against India in India immediately post the one-day World Cup. And then there's some at the back end of the summer between our home summer tests and two tests in New Zealand. So in all likelihood, our next three T20 squads could look quite different each and every time, and just not entirely sure who's going to be part of that. And Mitch, given his recent return to the test team, he's very much in that conversation as well. So great that he gets an opportunity here. Really excited to see what he sort of what stamp he brings to that team and what he does. He's I think it's been well documented today. He's a really great natural leader. He knows when to be one of the boys. He knows when to switch on, and he's someone that you want to follow when he's up and about. Great competitor. Really excited to see what he brings.
Might be a blessing in disguise that Paddy's got 6 weeks off with that wrist, George.
I think alongside with a number of those multi-format players, Davey Warner, Mitch Stark, Josh Hazlewood, Cam Green, there are a few that aren't heading across for the T20s. Pat was, in all likelihood, going to be part of that group as well. And then, even for Pat, even for a number of those guys who we do bring in, the fact is the World Cup starts on the 8th of October. Cracking game against India, but in the interim between this T20 series and the start of that, we've got 10 one-dayers. So that's a pretty large amount of cricket before you embark on what is hopefully going to be an 11-game World Cup. So we're really aware of just making sure that we, don't peak too early. And as much as you want to be fit and firing and ready for that first game of the World Cup versus India, and we'll absolutely have to be, we also want to make sure that we're playing our best cricket at the back end, hopefully, of that World Cup. So, yeah, Paddy will miss a few games, but I think he'll come on board. We've got 3 one-dayers against India before the World Cup. He'll come on board for one or two of those. There's a couple of warm-up games in the lead-up to the World Cup. So he'll have plenty of cricket. There's no question about that.
Speaking with Chairman of Selectors, George Bailey, how did Marnus Labuschagne take his non-selection? How was he?
He was pretty good. I'll say that. He was pretty good. He's disappointed that he's not in. I think he knows that when he's playing his best and when he has played his best one-day cricket for Australia, he can do a really important role for us. But he also, in the same breath, acknowledged that the role that we've wanted him to do hasn't been up to scratch of late, performance-wise, and he had a job to do. But I think, really importantly for Mark, given his age and because we know that he is someone who has succeeded at one-day international level, he gets a good opportunity to actually focus a little bit on some white ball cricket. So he's going to play some Australia A games for us against New Zealand at the same time as while those South African games are going on. He'll clearly be on standby for the World Cup should there be any alterations late in the piece. So we need him to keep going well. And I guess the other thing is you never quite know post the World Cup, who's going to continue playing? There's obviously some senior guys in that team, and Marnus of the age of in someone who we think is going to be a really important player for us again over the next couple of years as we start to build for other one-day major tournaments. So it's important that he gets back and gets back to playing his best cricket, and we certainly have confidence that he will do.
On wrap, we retain the Ashes. We won the World Series against India over there at Lord's. Be nice to have won it outright, but wouldn't it, the Ashes, George?
Yeah, I think that's why everyone's involved. Everyone likes to win. I think the players and staff have articulated that pretty well over the coming weeks. You go into every game and every series that you play wanting to win. There's no question about that. And I think they gave their absolute all. It was a captivating series, whether you like the result or don't like the result or feel like one team should have won over the other. It certainly had a lot of eyeballs on it, and I reckon if Cricket Australia started selling Ashes tickets for 2025 tomorrow, they'd start selling them straight away. So it was a fascinating contest. I think whenever you get a series as close as that, and I think that's as far as a series goes, the closest margins ever in an Ashes series across the 4 tests. I think that both teams would feel like there were things they could have done differently to perhaps impact the result. But, that's like a close grand final in football or whatever it might be. The closer the game, it's almost like you hang on the little moments a little longer and think about what I could have done. So, to be honest, that's no different to any series. You get back, you try and decompress a little bit and let the emotion come out of it and then reassess and review it and work out where you could have done better, what you might do differently next time.
Yeah, one of them might have been drop Davey Warner at 28.5. I was surprised he stayed in, George, just to be brutally honest.
Yeah, that's all right. That's right. Everyone's entitled to their opinion. I thought at times he looked excellent, had his energy back at the crease, a couple of really important innings for us. It was not the easiest spot to bat there at the top of the innings at times. For us, it did feel like whenever our boys pulled the pads on, the crowds decided to come over and the lights came on for a period there. So, challenge. You know, we know that Davey's closer to the end than the start, but still thought he contributed nicely throughout the series, caught nicely at times as well. So there's a lot of different ways you can make a contribution.
Yeah, George, he wants to finish in Sydney. What do you think he needs to do in your eyes just to achieve that?
To be honest, I think we'll probably pick that up once we get the full review on. And, I think most of the players and staff, the ones that didn't stay on and have a couple of days off in Europe, have sort of coming up for air next week. So I imagine we'll all get together at some point and have a bit of a yarn about what we think. But certainly our conversations in the last week have just been purely focused on this One Day World Cup, and that's where the eyes have been lifted to. I think between the World Cup and that first test of the home summer, there's not a great deal of time. Hence it'll be a challenge, I think, for some of those test boys to be part of that T20 squad at the back end of that. So we'll certainly have to pick it up at some point, but we certainly haven't started doing that as yet.
You won't have time to watch a grand final, mate.
Oh, jeez. Come on, George.
It's been that busy.
Now, George, I've got to come
always
clean.
Always time to watch Carl.
I've been potting you from the cheap seats. I still haven't gotten over the fact that you dropped Travis Head for the first test in India. So, you know, apologies if you've got any feedback, any direct feedback, but, God, you got that one wrong.
He came back in the next test. I think we talked about Travis in the lead up to the fact we think he's got a pretty good skill set at the top in the subcontinent, and that's where he ended up having a pretty good impact. So that was great for him. I think the greatest thing for Trav, because he was a reflection on what an excellent person he is and team man he is. Because no doubt he was disappointed, and as is every player when they are left out of the Australian team. But he took it really well, and after the initial disappointment, the next day he walks into the change rooms, and you wouldn't know, he just he just made it all about the team that week, and prepared on what he had to do, knowing that there was going to be an opportunity come up, and whether that was going to be the next test or one soon after. So I thought that was a great reflection on Trav. Those that know him well would expect nothing different, but it's those sorts of things I think are really important in a good team.
My word.
Well, mate, thanks for your time. We look forward to the build-up to the 2023 World Cup in India, South Africa first, and then over to India for some games as well. So all the best with it, and good luck.
Thank you.
Chandler Selectors George Bailey, Australian one-day team and T20 team. Going to be in action.
It's time for seven-time Timmy's Lucky Sevens.
Get on the phone, 8223-0000. We want you to play seven-time Timmy's Lucky Sevens quiz for Port Adelaide Locker Room Double Pass. The Giants coming to play the Power on Sunday at Adelaide Oval. And, Timmy, you'll like what they're wearing. The strip with the old retro strip from the late 90s to 2000s.
Lightning bolt.
They are bringing back the Thunderbolt.
It's actually one of the strips that was launched the night at the Entertainment Centre when we would launch our name, our nickname, the Power, also the three Guernseys, home and away, and that was the pre-season Guernsey. That was worn by Scott Hodges on the night. And we got out there and pumped the air with the old right hand. A few boys didn't know their right from left. Had to get them in order. But it was a terrific night. But that Guernsey always stuck out for me. And we didn't use it a great deal. No. And I reckon
it can be pre-season Guernsey for a few years. And then in 2003, it became your clash jumper.
Yeah. It actually, today, they had a lot of retro gear on sale. And at the Port Adelaide Port store at Alberton, people lined up down the street trying to get this retro thing.
How good is that?
I can't believe it.
It's going to be on sale as well.
I'll have a garage sale.
All right,
Sunday.
We're giving away tickets to that very game for the Locker Room after the break with the quiz. First to traffic.
At St Clair, there's a crash. Cheltenham Parade near the rail crossing. Ascot Park, another collision there. Dawes Road near the railway terrace. And Blair Road closed due to a fire. That's James Road between Old Blair Road and She Oak Road. Busy at the moment, Marion Road at the Anzac Highway intersection with a camera at Main South Road at Old Noolunga. SA's fastest supercars race is back. OTR Super Sprint at the Bend Motorsport Park from August 18 till 20. Get your tickets now at thebend.com.au. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Rowie and Timmy G on the 5AA Sports Show. He's a key defender for the Adelaide Crows
and a fan of fine films.
Join Tom Duday with David and Will each week on 5AA Breakfast, thanks to Leader Computers.
Leader Computers, Australia's largest Australian-owned PC manufacturer, based right here in Adelaide.
They used to say, a good plumber is hard to find. Having an industry-backed master plumber puts you on the right track. The industry badge ensures trust, integrity and strength to get the job done. Trust a Master Plumbers member to complete the job. Search for the Master Plumbers Badge of Approval at findamasterplumber.com.au. mpasa.com.au.
If you need a window,
and not just anything will do,
just call Statesman Windows,
back to redirect to you.
Nobody beats Statesman Windows, not on quality and certainly not on service. Windows, sliding doors, bifolds and more, made right here in Adelaide, factory direct to you. For windows when and where you want them, call Statesman Windows, states.com.au.
Windows when and where you want them.
There's only one thing more stubborn than kids. Parents. Oh. When it came to talking retirement, Mum would change the subject to anything else. And I mean anything else. Until she heard about Rentirement with Warnaclose Murray Bridge. No messy contracts, no hidden fees, just all the freedom and support of retirement living by renting. So have the Rentirement talk instead. Visit warnaclose.com.au. SA Community owned.
With IGA's Community Give Back Sale, you can make big savings.
And help support local causes.
Just look for tickets on specials, like Pepsi Solo or Schweppes 24 by 375 mil selected varieties, $20.90 each. Now at your local IGA. Offer ends August 8, while stocks last. Excludes Foodland.
Darren Steele from EDP Hotels knows firsthand how good DNA Guardian is for his staff and patrons.
We wanted more than just CCTV to protect our staff and patrons. DNA Guardian has provided us with a solution. It's an easy to implement system and we get great ongoing service and support from the DNA team. With DNA Guardian, we're protecting our greatest asset, our people.
From just $195 per month, it's the best security investment you can make. Visit dnasecuritysolutions.com.au.
The future's in our students' hands. That's why phones shouldn't be. The state government has banned mobile phones in all public high schools. So it's phones off while school's on. Learn more at phonesoff.sa.gov.au. A message from the Government of South Australia.
Are painful muscle cramps stopping you doing the things you love or waking you up at night? Caruso's Super Magnesium is a time-release formula with six types of magnesium which relieves painful muscle cramps when dietary intake is inadequate and supports muscle health and function. Caruso's Super Magnesium comes with a money-back guarantee and is available from leading pharmacies and health stores. Get back to doing what you love with Caruso Super Magnesium. Always read the label and follow the directions for use.
With more stores close to home and everyday low prices, great food lives at Foodland, the mighty South Aussies.
Rowie and Timmy G on the 5AA Sports Show.
It's time for seven-time Timmy's Lucky Sevens.
10 to 6, 822-3005. All our listeners are on the line. We're giving away another double to the Port Locker Room.
That we are, and I'll tell you what, it's going to be exciting game this weekend, a must win for Port Adelaide. We've got Ange on the line. G'day, Ange.
G'day, boys. How are you?
Okay, question number one, sir. In what year did Port Adelaide last win a finals game?
In what year?
Yep.
I would say 2019.
Incorrect. Let's go to Phil at Penunda. G'day, Phil.
G'day, Timmy. 21.
Correct.
Correct.
Well done, Phil. Question two. Which Port Adelaide coach has the most finals wins?
Choco.
Choco is correct. Mark Williams. Question three.
Hang on, how many?
He got eight.
And how many's Ken had?
He's got five.
All right.
Question three. Yes or no, is Lindsay Thomas the oldest player to make his club debut for Port Adelaide?
Oh, Phil.
Let's go to Doug. G'day, Doug. Yes or no?
His answer was no, wasn't it? So I'll go yes.
Correct. Good on you, Dougie. He was 30 years and 52 days. Question four. Who was the leading goal kicker for GWS this season?
It's Toby Green.
Correct. Well done. Question five, Doug. Has former Giant, now Port star, Jeremy Finlayson, kicked more goals for Port or GWS so far?
I've been through the list quiz about three times, and every time the questions involve Finlayson, I've bombed out.
Port or GWS? Which one you reckon he's
kicking? I'll go for GWS.
Well played, GWS. You've broken through.
Okay, that's a big milestone, Doug. Question six. At which stadium have Port won the most AFL games? Remembering we started in 97, and of course we were at the old football park for quite some time, and then we've gone to Adelaide Oval. So where have we had our most wins?
Yeah, it'd have to be Football Park.
Yeah, well done, Dougie.
Doug.
He led the witness. Timmy led the witness then.
Which player star holds the club record for the most disposals in a season? Hint? Well.
Oh, that's too easy.
Yeah,
then.
I'm not going to say give the hint. Hint. The hint's too, yeah, but he's still playing today.
The most disposals.
So he holds the record for the most disposals in one season for Port.
What, for Port Adelaide?
Yeah, for Port Adelaide.
The player.
Yep, the player. He's a...
would have to be Travis Boak.
Oh, no.
I thought he was about to say the other name, but that is a tragedy.
Can only be one more player.
Josh, g'day, Josh.
Howdy.
Who do you reckon had the most disposals in one season for Port Adelaide? Who holds the club record? Most disposals in a season?
Probably has to be the Brownlow Medal winner, Ollie Weinfeld.
Oh, Josh, you have slipped in at the end.
No flies on you,
those dude. Double pass to the locker room to see Port Adelaide take on GWS this Sunday, 13th of August, 4:10 at Adelaide Oval. Book your tickets at portadelaidefc.com.au.
Oh, feel for Dougie there.
Oh, shattered for Doug.
He got through the hard question.
I even got the...
Fallen short.
Okay, the Crows Injury Report is thanks to Western Hospital. Provide the type of quality care you deserve. Visit westernhospital.com.au. Let's go from the bottom up. Chase Jones, Liz Frank, season out. Tom Duday, knee out. Nick Murray, knee out. Jordan Butts, the second Liz Frank, out. Season. Taylor with a foot. Andrew McPherson with a quaddly do. Isaac Rankin is a silly Billy chance to play. Here's Darren Burgess.
So Isaac's done everything that we've asked of him so far. We still have main training tomorrow. And if he gets through that and he passes a couple more markers that we need him to pass, then he should put his hand up for selection this weekend.
Marvellous recovery, that. Absolutely marvellous.
As long as it holds together.
I wouldn't risk him.
Brisbane. So I think they're going to. I think they're going to, by the sound of it.
Every game's a must win.
He is our Sam Kerr.
Well, I think it's going to be dice rolled. There you go.
Play him or don't play him, Rowie?
Yeah, roll him. No, I'm playing him.
Roll him.
No, if you're right, you're right. With a hammer, you know if you're right.
Yep.
Yeah, exactly. So Port Adelaide's injury list, thanks to Western Hospital, the type of quality care you deserve. Trent McKenzie expected to miss a month with the PCL. Now, we've also got the guys that had illness, Finlayson, Bergman, Farrell, all expected to be available this week. Also with them, the two concussion boys in Lockie Jones and Alia Lear are progressing well, but they'll have the test. I think both will play. That's my call, not Western Hospital's or Port Adelaide's. Charlie Dixon is the worry for me. That foot injury and hearing what Chad Corn said, I'm thinking that's a no and that maybe he may have to go in. Scott Lysette is faring well after the surgery he had to his cartilage on his left knee. So we'll just see what sort of time frame in the next few days he comes up as. Of course, Sam Hayes hasn't been able to be available for a ruck because he's had a shoulder. He's still 2 to 3 weeks away as well. So, and they've got Cleary out with a back. For the season. Georgiades out with a knee for the season. Sin with a hamstring, who probably won't play again this year. So they've got a fair list down there at Alberton.
Just one last text before the break. You wimped out, you two, asking George Bailey the obvious question.
Which one?
How does Mitch Marsh get to captain Australia ahead of proven Shield 50 over and BBL captain Travis Head, Colin from Golden Grove? Colin, I don't know whether Travis a walk-up start. And if you're the captain, you've got to be the walk-up start, don't you? Yeah, was that the obvious question?
That was the T20 one. Oh, I wouldn't have thought it was the obvious question. That's why we didn't ask it.
Fair
do you think of it, Sam?
Mitch Marsh has been very good in the T20 arena.
Did you think of
it, Sam?
Did you think of that question?
No, I did not.
So we're all in trouble with Colin. So
come
on,
Cole.
Colin, come and produce the show next week. No problem. 3 minutes to six.
The 5AA Sports Show with Rowie and Timmy G.
What you do in your loo is entirely up to you, but a suite en suite every day is a treat. Bathrooms by Design create a luxurious bathroom experience you can cherish every time. We can help you create your dream, a classic bathroom with a clawfoot bath, a stylish minimalist ensuite that's classy and timeless. It's up to you. A new loo? Very you. Reward yourself every day with a luxurious bathroom, thanks to Bathrooms by Design. Go to bathroomsbydesign.com.au.
If you're on the market for a new Mitsubishi, you'll love the team at Agostino Mitsubishi. They've some serious runs on the board when it comes to exceptional service, over 35 years worth. And how's this for peace of mind? Get a 10-year warranty and 10-year cap price servicing on the entire Mitsubishi range. Don't muck around. See the team at Agostino Mitsubishi, Nailsworth and Elizabeth. Exclusions and conditions including Mitsubishi servicing apply.
Alrighty. Now, I've told you before, you don't just do a good barbie. You actually become a tong master. You don't just flip the snags and think you're this, that and the other. No, you earn the title of Backyard Hospitality Director. So when you do, you got to get the very best outdoor kitchen from Adelaide Outdoor Kitchens. Now, you can add the best appliances, bar, fridge, pizza oven. Stun your guests with one of these, a custom-made concrete benchtop.
They excite me, these, the indoor concrete bench tops. They're handmade. They can really update your kitchen space, custom-made for you. I like uniqueness, and this would be just yours. You'd say, hey, no one else in the world has that, but I do.
Correct.
Boom, boom, boom.
And this is the time to do it. Get in and get a consultation because
do it.
We are probably about 7 weeks away from daylight savings. So what are you doing then? You're going outside and you're doing barbies and the like. There's a bit of news for you.
When is spring?
Spring starts the 1st of September.
1st of September.
Now I'm going to get pulled up because that's not 100% accurate. We sort of call it the 1st of September, but it's all about the solstice. So I jumped on it.
You know when I know? It's when those bloody black and white magpies start
swooping. Yeah, they're coming. So get that consultation done. I'll get a quote from, and you can go to Seaford Meadows showroom, have a look around there, Farrow Circuit, and just get on to them at the website, adelaideoutdoorkitchens.com.au.
Is there a God? What is the meaning of life? Do I actually need unlimited data to watch a few cat videos on my commute? Cute.
Question everything, especially your telco plan. Get the data you need at low prices with Aldi Mobile.
Every 2 years, if you're age 50 to 74, you'll get a blue and white package from the National Bowel Cancer Screening Program. It's your free bowel screening test kit, and it could save your life. Here's what to do. Take it to the bathroom and put it right where you can see it. Not in a drawer, but on the benchtop or on the toilet seat or in the middle of the floor. So the next time you have to go, you'll remember to use it. Please, don't put off the chance to save your life. Get to it. Visit bowelcancer.org.au for more information.
Online, on DAB Digital Radio, and on 1395 AM. Talking Adelaide. This is Adelaide's 5AA.
Clear tonight, showers developing tomorrow and 20. With the 6 o'clock news, I'm Mel Usher.
Get 10-year warranty and 10 years capped price servicing on the new Mitsubishi Outlander at Agostino Mitsubishi.
A home in the foothills has been destroyed by fire. The alarm was raised at James Road in Belair just after 3 this afternoon. Chanel Zampoya from the CFS says there were more than 40 firefighters on scene at the height of the blaze.
The property, which was also housing a caravan, car and motorbikes, is believed to be a total loss, with estimated damages in excess of $600,000.
The cause is yet to be determined. The woman accused of murdering her parents with her own insulin has been granted home detention bail. A court finding Raylene Polymiadis would be at risk of hardship with her diabetes treatment if she remained in custody. The 62-year-old has been charged with 2 counts of murder, her mother Brenda Anderson in 2022 and father Linton Anderson in 2023. She has another court date in December. Discretionary spending has fallen for the third straight month as households adjust to rising living costs. The Bureau of Statistics says overall household spending is up on June last year, and non-discretionary spending has recorded its slowest growth since January. ABS Head of Business Indicators Ben Dauber says right across the country there's been a slowdown in spending.
Definitely coming over the last couple of years, there's been some different results across the country coming out of the pandemic period. WA has performed differently than, say, New South Wales or Victoria. But right across the country we're seeing spending slowing, but we're also seeing those high prices remain pretty consistent.
The Prime Minister has accused the opposition of peddling conspiracy theories about the Indigenous voice. The Coalition has again grilled the government on possible plans for treaties with Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islanders if the nation votes yes in the referendum. Labor maintains a nationwide treaty isn't the priority right now. Anthony Albanese telling Parliament the No campaign is refusing to deal with the facts.
What we have here
is the conspiracy theories
colliding with each other. They're struggling to get their scares straight. I mean, what role did Marcia Langton play in the faking of the moon landing, Mr. Speaker? What was the role of the Uluru Statement from the Heart in that?
A global investigation has led to charges being laid against 19 Australian men accused of running an online child abuse network. Federal police began an investigation following a tip-off from the FBI last year. Two of the men have since been sentenced. 13 children have also been removed from further harm. AFP Commander Helen Schneider says it was a coordinated effort between federal, state and territory police.
It really demonstrates, I think, the commitment and connection we have across the country and how we can connect in internationally. We see it as a significant outcome, and I think that this outcome should definitely serve as a warning to those who are preying on our most vulnerable, that we are looking for you, we will find you and we will arrest you.
Now turning to 5AA Sport.
Collect the newest 2023 AFL footy cards available at Sports Card World Regent Arcade.
The Matildas will be watching closely tonight when France take on World Cup newcomer Morocco at Hindmarsh. The winner will play Australia in Brisbane on Saturday for a place in the semi-finals. Former Matilda Amy Harrison believes the luck may run out tonight for the Moroccans.
To their first ever World Cup, into the knockout stages. I think that this one might be just a little bit too far. France have so much quality, but this you can't even predict anything this World Cup. Upsets have been every day.
Essendon ruckman Andrew Phillips will call time on his AFL career at the end of the season. He's played 79 senior games across 12 seasons for the Bombers, Blues and Giants. West Coast's Luke Shuey will also retire at the end of the season. The 2018 Norm Smith medalist has played 247 games for the Eagles so far, kicking 141 goals. While North Melbourne's Ben Cunnington will play his final game this weekend. And the Australian Boomers will play the University of Houston in Cairns tomorrow in preparation for the FIBA World Cup. Now checking 5AA traffic.
At Wingfield, there's a breakdown on the north-south motorway near the Port River Expressway. Edinburgh, crash Peachy Road near Walmer Road. And St Clair, a crash there too. Cheltenham Parade near the rail crossing, making it pretty slow for the drive home. Cameras, Majors Road, O'Halloran Hill and Seaford Road at Seaford. Receive the free bowel screening test kit. Don't put it off. If you're aged between 50 and 74, take the kit to the bathroom and get to it. It's the free test that could save your life. Adelaide's most accurate traffic on 5AA.
Now the 5AA weather.
Get the Toyota forklift advantage. Visit toyotamaterialhandling.com.au.
Clear tonight, down to 8, showers developing tomorrow 20, Thursday a shower or 2, 15, and then cloudy and 15 on Friday. Right now it is 15 degrees. Now let's hear what's happening on Nine News tonight.
You can trust Nine News is live and local. While others do their news from Melbourne, Nine News is made in Adelaide for Adelaide. Weeknights at 5.
First in Adelaide's Nine News at 5.
Nightly at 6.
And the unprecedented police operation.
We go to some breaking news now and crews are right now at the scene.
And that's why the switch is on to Nine News.
With more stores close to home and everyday low prices, great food lives at Foodland, the mighty South Aussies.
Rowie and Timmy G on the 5AA Sports Show.
6 minutes after six on this Tuesday night, Ned McHenry's fishing show coming up at 6:30 for TJM. I have heard that he has a really big prize on the program tonight. He's told me, in fact, to actually plug that.
Well, he likes to bring stuff in, doesn't he? He's a bit like a... a Tuesday night Father Christmas.
A little bit of an Oprah. Yeah, he just, just give it
a bit of an Oprah.
Just all mix into one. Very entertaining. 6:30
You get a reel. You get a reel.
Cross shortly as well to Highmarsh Stadium, where we will have a massive crowd in for the round of 16 game. France and Morocco in the FIFA Women's World Cup. The winner will play Australia. And you can also tune into the Foodland live stream on Facebook and YouTube with more stores close to home and everyday low prices. We know great food lives at Foodland. They are the mighty South Aussies.
They are indeed. Now,
oh, to you, mighty South Aussie.
Yeah.
Our next guest.
Oh, I tell you, Stephen, if you have played a game of amateur footy in this state, there is a fair chance this bloke would have umpired you at some stage of it. He is about to line up for his 1,200th Adelaide Footy League game on Saturday for a record in the competition. His name is Barry Lewis. G'day, Barry.
Howdy, guys. How are you?
Mate, you're an amazing person. I mean, umpiring for 50 years... At 77 years of age, how do you keep doing it?
What was the question?
Is that what you said when people ask you for a free kick? No. Mate, this is incredible.
I mean, I've never stopped. So I've slowed down now with my running, but I was never fast. Hey, Timmy, I umpired you in your first two grand finals.
Well, I actually was saying, I remember you when I was just a little nipper. I reckon I was probably about 10 playing for Semaphore Park. And, I remember you umpiring way back then. So that's incredible.
Your first grand final was a draw.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. So
you played again.
Yeah, so they're the good old days, mate. But, geez, how have you kept it going? I mean, it's 1,200 in the Adelaide Footy League, but you've actually umpired over 2,637 games because you did do all those junior games and other competitions. It's just a staggering number. Yeah. How did you do it so much? Because, you know, most people won't umpire because they can't handle the abuse. How do you handle them?
Well, having been a policeman.
Yes.
And most people knew, I never really got a lot of flat, a little bit here and there, but you just got to learn to turn the other cheek.
So a night in the cells was enough to keep them at bay?
That was it. Like if somebody got real abusive and rude, I'd say, do you know who I am?
Yeah.
You better ask somebody, and somebody said, hey, he's a policeman. Yeah.
Oh, God. 50 seasons, Baz. Congratulations. And a state record 2,637 times you've done local footy. Why?
Well, I've always loved the game. I was always a B grade player. I played A grade for Ethelton in A4, but all with my Colts, or after Colts and B grade at Handel, and then B grade down at Encounter Bay, and then B grade in Flinders Park. So I was a B grade player, but just when I got hooked on umpiring, I just wanted to keep doing it.
Mm.
And because I love the game.
That is brilliant, Baz. We need more of you. Now, have you ever made a mistake?
Not that I can recall.
Maybe 1973.
There is an art to it, isn't there? What is the art? What makes a good umpire, Baz?
Talk to players.
Yep.
Turn the other cheek.
Yep.
With criticism, just be a bit firm here and there, but communicate.
Mm.
Communicate, smile. If you do make a mistake, which I haven't made yet, you got to admit, and then the next break, look, I'm sorry about that, I was wrong there.
Mm. So when you make a mistake, do you even it up?
I don't quite know what you mean.
Because I reckon you naturally would, wouldn't you? You would, you know.
I reckon that's nature.
Yeah, of course it is.
Human nature.
And Baz, what do you do with the younger guys that come through, and how would you encourage somebody that's at an age that says, look, you know, I'm a C-grade player, I think I might take up umpiring. What sort of advice would you give to those guys?
Come out. Just come out and do it.
Okay.
Come out, you'll learn the techniques, and then the idea is to remember that the any screaming and criticism from the crowd, don't hear it.
Yep.
Or try not to hear it. That's what turns a lot of umpires up early, guys, is the early criticism.
Yep.
And, I mean, I coached the Amateur League umpires for 10 years, and I've seen a lot who have dropped off and just because of the criticism.
Yeah.
But the idea is not to let it get to you and just keep...
Good man.
Keep doing it. Keep doing it. And keep it, if you enjoy it, keep doing it. While I keep enjoying it, I'll keep doing it.
That is brilliant, Bass. Now, have you got the original Acme Thunder? You know, have you blown any peas out of that whistle? Have you got a golden one? Did they give you a golden whistle, Barry Lewis?
No, but throughout my career, I won 7.
Wow.
Not counting.
We've got ourselves a humble umpire.
He's the Lance Armstrong without the EPOs.
That's it.
Baz, all due credit yourself, mate.
7-time Baz's quiz. That's unreal.
I tell you what, I've got about four whistles in my bag now that are at least 12 years old.
Wow.
Goodness me.
Just give them a good wash and keep going, and they'll hold up, especially the Acme Thunderers. I like those new plastic ones. I haven't got one, but those new plastic ones are really good.
Oh, God.
Now,
Baz, if I work it out, what would an umpire run in a game, and you've done, 2,637 of them over 50 years, I reckon you would have run around Australia twice.
The world.
I carry my little time with me, and because I'm doing reserves footy now, and I'll run about 6 kilometres in a game.
Great.
That's 77. That is incredible, mate. A lot of people trying to just get out for their daily walk at your age, mate. You're up by a footy. It's amazing.
Yeah.
Hey, over the years, Baz, what sort of changes have you seen in the game, you know, from way back 50 years ago?
The first year they had that, they brought that diamond in the first year of the umpire.
I remember that. Yeah, played that.
Lasted 6 months, didn't it?
Yeah. I reckon straight to the square, wasn't it, after that?
Then they brought the square in, which was... So that was first. I reckon, other than that, I've been a long time with the Adelaide Footy League, and the Adelaide Footy League have cleaned up footy terrifically.
Yes.
They support the umpires tremendously, and they also are very, very strong with anybody who digresses.
Yeah, Curtis has done a great job. Hey, Baz, what's the hardest decision? What's the one that... got it. Because a lot of them aren't rules, they're interpretations. Is it holding the ball?
Well, I really think holding the ball, you know, has the player had an opportunity? Has he at least tried to get rid of it?
Uh-huh.
They're the fundamentals, but holding the ball is always a tickly one, because the crowd will yell holding the ball, and if you don't pay it, they'll get a few boos. But that's the main one of contention. Other than that, I think the rules are pretty clear.
Okay.
Pushing the back of the hand.
That's
pushing
a half
the back at the moment. I reckon when a player pushes a player out with his body, at times that really can be a push in the back.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? They take him. So you must, I always say, you got to let him compete with you.
Yeah.
So, or her compete with you, whatever game I'm doing.
What about ruck infringements? They give me the earth of kits.
Yeah, well, all my big day career, I was a ruckman.
Yeah, okay.
And it never, I think the ruck, see, in amateur league, there's no third man up. There's third man up allowed.
Yep.
And I reckon with the ruck, what's the intent of the ruckman? Is his intention to go for the ruck? Where's his eye?
Yeah.
He looks at the other player and runs into him, free kick.
Yeah.
Mm.
If he doesn't, if he's looking up at the ball and they crash into one another, play on.
Yeah, Baz, for me, I think I watch a lot of amateur footy. My lad's playing there now. I watch Sandful footy. I think the two leagues just allow more play to go on rather than just keep pulling it up with lots of ticky-touch free kicks that we're all debating whether it's a free kick or not. I just love the fact that you pay the obvious and you move on.
Yeah, that's it.
That's it. That's the secret.
And I reckon with the Adelaide Footy League now, the way that they look after the umpires, that's to their credit, and that keeping umpires there. There's an umpire this year that I was umpiring a women's game the other week, and he came out and I said, "Oh, they made a change. You umpire with me?" He said, "No, I'm on the boundary." And I said, "What's the matter?" And he was quite a good umpire.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, "What's up?" He said, "No, I can't stand the criticism, Bez. I can't stand it. I can't stand the criticism of players. I can't stand the criticism when you walk off." And I thought, all right, well, I won't buy into that with him. But I said, well, if you can be bigger than that, you can come back into it.
Well done.
But I don't think he is. He's going to just run the boundary.
That is disappointing. Buffheads like me that shoot our gob off at umpires that wreck it for everyone, Baz.
Yeah.
No, you wouldn't do that.
No. I love umpires. Oh. Baz, you're a legend.
Well, Barry, congratulations, well mate. Done. It's an incredible record. It's one that, like I said, I think there's...
Never be beaten.
There's not an amateur footy player, I reckon, in this state that hasn't had Barry as an umpire.
There you go.
Unbelievable. Well done, mate. Congratulations on it.
Hey, thanks a lot, fellas.
Well, Barry Lewis, an incredible career with the police force as well. Mm. Was there for many, many years and a respected both umpire, policeman, and just all-round citizen.
Oh, I'll say it again. 2,637 games. Barry Lewis, you star. Let's go to Plimpton Park. Hello, Paul.
G'day. How you going, Rowie? And Tim. Yeah, I met Barry on a couple of occasions. You're right, he's nature's gentleman.
He is.
When I was playing footy down around Semaphore. Yeah, I just rang up before, and I really didn't want to come on here, but spoke to the lady on the phone. In that conversation that Kane Corns and Buckley had, it goes on, I don't know if you read it, goes on to say he didn't need to ring them up because he spoke to them when they came to train with them.
Yeah.
Did you see that?
Yes, which...
So,
they can't, especially pre-season.
They do regularly.
They come out and umpire match simulations and the like. Yep. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. They train with them in Melbourne. So there's an opportunity if you're a coach, you can say, hey, what about that? You know, I mean, we don't get that privilege, do we? They don't come to South Australia to do that. I don't know.
They do, Paul.
Oh, do they?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. And we've got Eleni Gruftis here. We've got a couple of South Australians on the panel.
Yeah. The late young
If you want them, they'll get on a kite. They'll come out.
Okay. Yeah well, I just thought, you know, that's probably why Buckley didn't, that these coaches in Melbourne didn't need to ring up. I don't know if Kenny Hinkley gets that privilege to have them there. And you mentioned he might. Well, that'd be the perfect place to find that out. But, thanks for listening.
It's no good. Worries, Paul. It's an opportunity, too, to get that umpire and perhaps... Perhaps he goes missing.
Oh, what are you saying?
Carly Jargon. Carly Jargon.
Tim, what are you saying, mate?
Just being a fool.
Juniper, don't be a fool.
I
told you, don't let me drag you down.
You tried, and I got back out of it. Got back out of the hole.
20 after 6.
The 5AA Sports Show with Rowie and Timmy G. Join us every Friday just after 3 p.m. where renowned Adelaide chef Chris Jarmer joins Jade Robren for the 5AA Food and Wine Show. Thanks to Smeg, seamlessly pairing performance with design. Taste the difference with Smeg. And Parafield Airport Liquor. They have the perfect partner for every dish.
If you need a window, and not just anything will do, just call Statesman Window. Back to redirect to you.
Nobody beats Statesman Windows, not on quality and certainly not on service. Windows, sliding doors, bifolds and more. Made right here in Adelaide. Factory direct to you. For windows when and where you want them, call Statesman Windows. States.com.au.
Windows when and where you want them. Windows when and where you want them.
When it comes to talking retirement, parents will change the subject to anything. And I mean anything. There's things you just can't unhear. So save yourself the overshares. Talk to them about rentirement at Warner Close, Murray Bridge instead. With no messy contracts and no hidden fees, your parents can get all the perks of retirement and the support they need without giving up their freedom. Have the rentirement talk with your parents. Visit warnerclose.com.au. SA Community Owned.
If you're in the market for a new car, you've got to put the new Cherry Emotive 5 from Cherry Glen Osmond on your list. It's ready for immediate delivery. They also have low mileage demo models ready for immediate delivery too. From just 33,000 drive away, even less for a demo, the Cherry Emotive 5 has the sort of features you'd expect to find in a car three times its price. Heated seats, remote engine start, 360 degree camera, parking sensors, the list goes on. Visit gocherry.com.au or call into Cherry Glen Osmond next to Formula Honda.
To celebrate 70 years in solar, Solar Heart is giving you the chance to win a Tesla Model 3 electric vehicle worth up to $70,000. Simply buy a Solar Heart solar power system, Solar Heart water heater, heat pump or home battery and enter for your chance to win. Get smart. Get Solar Heart. Terms and conditions apply. Visit solarheart.com.au for details. Open to AU residents 18 plus. Ends 30th of September 2023. SA permit T23/871.
Ready? Let's push it. With up to 5.5% interest available on an ING savings account for eligible customers. Your hard-earned cash can work even harder for you. Make bank on your moolah with an ING savings account. Now, let's give your savings a run for its money. Come on, do it.
Rate includes additional variable rate of 4.95% on eligible balances up to 100k. General advice only. CT&Cs at ing.com.au. ING ABN 24000893292. AFSL 229823.
It's always been my happy place. When the old arthritis set in, I thought my gardening days were over. Suffered for a while, actually. Nearly kicked myself when Carol told me about the joint replacement clinic. There's no gap to pay with health insurance and everything's included. Transport, physio, aftercare, they really look after you. Turns out I didn't need to fork out a cent to keep my trowel.
Ask your GP or visit thejointreplacementclinic.com.au. Renewing mobility, restoring life.
With more stores close to home and everyday low prices, great food lives at Foodland, the mighty South Aussies.
Roey and Timmy G on the 5AA Sports Show.
24 minutes after six, the crowd is building, the atmosphere continues to build here in Adelaide around the FIFA Women's World Cup.
It certainly does. And the last time we caught up with this young lady, we had, I think it was Brazil and Panama going at it. Yeah.
Yes.
Jessica Braithwaite, Nine's news weather presenter. G'day, mate.
G'day. Now, look, last time we talked, I was caught up in the Brazilian vibes. That's I really right. loved the, they had the drums and the chants, but I tell you what, you haven't heard the Moroccans yet. They are fantastic. They've got not only the beautiful drumming, but these wonderful traditional instruments. I think it's called a cacanha. I had a go at one of them already. I'm getting into the rhythms, and I think I'm going to tell you, I'm going to call it early, I'm on Team Morocco for tonight.
Woohoo! So am I.
Yes. I like the way you said Morocco, Moroccan.
How good's that?
I told you I'm getting into the rhythm of it all, but I have to say, the French, I don't know where that they haven't turned up yet. So there's not much competition at the moment. Hopefully they turn up on the field tonight, yeah. But I tell you what, it's a great atmosphere already.
I was going to say, France don't have siestas. What are they doing? They should be up and about. Get in there.
Yeah. But Jessica, it swept the nation and it swept us here. Oh. We'll get a massive crowd tonight, won't we?
Yep, and everyone's already piling in. But what I love seeing is the young people. And yes. That makes me sound old, I know. But I love seeing the young kids coming through, and particularly the young girls. It's just so inspiring for them to be able to come and see this right here in Adelaide. And the vibe is just beautiful. It's a lovely crowd. There's a lot of families here. It's a really, like, it's a really feel-good atmosphere. And it's honestly, it's hard not to get, you know, not to have a big smile on your face and to kind of get swept up in it. Even if you haven't, you know, really been watched soccer or football before, it's hard not to just really get swept up in it all.
Jessica, for Nine News weather presenter, we had a glorious Adelaide day. What's it going to be like tonight? Will it be dew? Will you have to rug up? Will it be cold, Jessica?
It's looking good, yeah, definitely rug up. It's one of those things, you know, as soon as the sun goes down, you can feel the ice in the air, but it's going to be dry, so that's good. So, like, we had the sun out today, so we've got the clear skies, but, you know, like, by the time we're into the middle of the game, it might be dropping down to around 10, 11 degrees, so definitely be a chilly one. So we have to jump around a lot and cheer loudly to keep warm.
Well, you start dancing with those Moroccans, I think you'll be all right. You'll keep as warm as toast.
Yeah, I think they need me in the band, so I better get back to it.
Good on you, Jess.
Thank you very much, Jess. Appreciate your time.
And that Nine News weather presenter there, Jessica Braithwaite. And that's the thing about this world game. That's Morocco. It's France. It's Nigeria.
I was driving into that. They were already setting up. They had trucks with the flags and everything happening. And
so it means so much to them. It's their first World Cup ever.
Yeah. Brings families together. Brings nations together. It is just swept me. Fair dinkum.
It has been excellent so far. But it'd be interesting to see what would happen if Australia dropped out. Where that interest level goes. I just hope that we sustain it, because I think the Matildas are carrying all of this. And because of their success, we're all going with it. Keep going, Matildas, is the message.
Well, the winner tonight plays the Matildas, so we have an investment in tonight's game.
We have, haven't we?
About that. 27 after 6, it's time for us to say goodbye, because Ned McHenry is waiting in the stalls of Fishing Show next.
The 5AA Sports Show, Roey and Timmy G.
5AA Breakfast.
The Prime Minister's committed to consider having a